This is a HeadGum Podcast.
The reason I'd enjoyed such smooth sailing for so long hadn't been, as I'd assumed, because I was careful and diligent and good at my job. The truth was that, in all those years, I hadn't written anything important enough to suppress. This was journalist Gary Webb in his 2002 memoir, Into the Buzzsaw. 2 years later, he was dead of suicide. Webb's claim to fame, and infamy among the U.S. government and its media allies, was his 1996 San Jose Mercury News bombshell Dark Alliance, which detailed the CIA's complicity in the crack epidemic that devastated black communities in the United States. As detailed in a 2014 Intercept piece by Ryan Devereaux, the CIA's backlash to Webb's scoop was swift and personal, using mainstream outlets like the Los Angeles Times and the Washington Post to smear Webb's reputation, aided by friendly reporters motivated by professional jealousy. Webb's factual, though imperfect, reporting was quickly relegated to the conspiracy theory bin, and his career would then spiral downward into oblivion. But the evidence remains convincing, as shown in the congressional record, that the CIA enabled the flow of narcotics and money that polluted urban neighborhoods with crack cocaine in the 1980s, destroying lives via drug dependency and prison time. And it was the drug's uniquely addictive quality that inspired the name of a signature dessert at an upscale bakery spinoff of David Chang's Momofuku, crack pie. Founded in 2008 in New York City by Chang's then pastry chef Christina Tosi, the Sugar Broker was soon popular enough to stand on its own, with other signature desserts like its compost cookie and cereal milk ice cream. Today, with locations in New York, Los Angeles, Las Vegas, Washington, D.C., and Washington State, as well as nationwide shipping and grocery store distribution, Tosi's Momofuku spinoff is arguably as well known as Momofuku itself, and Tosi has joined Chang as a cookbook-slinging celebrity chef. In 2019, facing criticism over a luxury dessert shop referencing the name of a drug that immiserated black neighborhoods, founder Tosi released a statement announcing the renaming of crack pie. The statement was updated in June 2020 to apologize more extensively. But even with its new name, the pie remains so delectable, it wouldn't be a shock to learn this upscale cakery was funded by the CIA, though I risk my professional reputation for even speculating. This week on Doughboys, Milk Bar. Welcome to Doughboys, the podcast about chain restaurants. I'm Nick Weiger, along with my co-host, the Spoon Man, Mike, fourth Thursday of November, Mitchell.
Oh, there's a reference to my Simpsons name.
Mitch, you are correct. This is from Maxwell B. Quote, this is a lighthearted roast based on the name Mitch used in the Treehouse of Horror episode he was credited in. Mike, October 31st, Mitchell, or Michael?
Michael, October 31st, Mitchell, yeah, that my mom and dad didn't like.
I think it's very funny. I'm thankful for everyone in the Dough Fam and my own wonderful family, including my beautiful wife and fellow Doughboys listener, pronunciation Mikey. Mikey, how about that? Spoonman@gmail.com.
I had a dream. My dad was in my dream last night. My dad's passed away. Mm-hmm. So my dad was in my dream last night, and he didn't want to hang out with me. And I was like, why don't you want to hang out with me? He's like, you're being weird. That was kind of what the dream was about. I was like,
tracks for me
fuck?
So far. That's wild.
Fucking asshole. Yeah, well, whatever.
I had a dream I was at a food truck with NBA player DeMar DeRozan.
Really?
Yeah, and I said, hey, what's up, DeMar? He's like, hey, Nick. He, like, knew who I was.
That's it?
That was it, yeah. We both had kind of boring dreams.
That's all that happened?
Yeah, pretty much.
I was being weird. My dad wouldn't hang out with me, and then you said hi to DeMar DeRozan.
Yeah, and he knew who I was.
That's all that happened? Did you get food?
We were in line for a food truck, and I don't remember eating.
That's the thing with the dreams. You never...
You don't get closure a lot of times.
You don't get the closure you really want.
Yeah.
It's fucked up.
It sucks.
Come on. Can't the human body get it right?
Come on, dreams.
Yeah, Step it up.
Have you had like any other memorable dreams
come
lately?
On, REM. Because
you're
REM
not a
cycle.
Come on, REM. Because you were a man who like didn't dream a lot for a while, and now you're kind of like, I feel like going hardcore into dreamland, much like Little Nemo, because you got your new CPAP.
We're
and
talking
that's
about
giving
the CPAP
sleep.
Stuff, but I'm telling you that I told you that I got foggy today.
That's right.
I'm getting foggy a lot.
Yeah, I said we should call you London Mitchell. You're so foggy.
Yes, you did say this.
And it crushed in here. Everyone liked it. And I was like, I gotta say this again.
I've been very foggy. I think the air is shooting into my head. I don't know what's going on. I think it might be an inner ear thing, but I also sound like stuffed up. I don't get it.
Weird.
Whatever. It's gonna be fine. You know what I've figure it out is that I was on the way over here. I was driving over here. I was looking at my phone as I was driving.
Shouldn't be doing that.
Classic Mitch.
Looking at my phone, driving, watching videos. Barely looking up the entire time. You know what? The thing that bummed me out is like there's every Instagram account is just food. It's all so much food stuff now.
Yeah, right.
And we've done this for 8 years, and we are like social media. We've never broken out to mass public appeal.
We did like we had like a TikTok account we used briefly, and then we just forgot it. I think it was to promote our Spotify live show.
Oh right,
we still post to that weekly.
Oh, we do?
Regularly, yeah. Okay. All the social clips go there. So.
Oh, well, there you go. But we don't like go on there and being like, hey, I'm going to review the new, you know, whatever, these new Ruffles that have a...
Do you watch any of those?
No, I don't. I'm not on TikTok.
They're like, it's like when I heard there was a new lobster taco in LA, I had to check it out. I'm at like the Lobster Shack. And yeah. Like, that is like what it is.
Wow.
And they have millions of views.
Wow.
It's like the quesadilla was bomb. That's like all you do.
The thing is, though, if we did,
that's all you gotta do.
We would like we could like try to do those, thinking like, oh, we got this, and then we'd like not get any traction, and then we'd feel like shit. So why bother?
Can we just try one? Can we do one?
I'll do one with you.
All right.
We're here in Headgum Studios. I got the new Coke Zero. It's gonna take a swig.
You're already doing it too. It's gonna be more laid back than that, even.
Oh, like more low energy.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, we're here at Headgum Studios. I got this Coke Zero.
Oh, fuck. No, it's going to be narrator. You're going to be like, today we checked out, like, we've been hearing a lot about Coke Zero. Today okay. We checked it out. Like, that's what you have to do.
So here at Headgum Studios, you know, I was taking a piss earlier and looking at my phone, and I was reading about this thing, Coke Zero. And I was like, well, I got to get this thing. So I got this. I'm of a taste. And then I'll take a piss afterwards, let you know how that feels.
So your character is kind of a guy whose life circulates around piss?
Yeah, I think so. Piss man.
Looking for the next piss?
Yeah, real piss guy.
Shit, I just pissed. I got to think of the next one. What am I going to do next? Water, Coke Zero? Anyway, we should get our guests in here. Yeah. We suck.
Yeah, this is bad.
Dog's asleep.
Demi is now become a fixture of the studio, very, very, which we love. She is lying on her side, being as quiet as a Doughboys audience member. catching some Z's.
I've corrected you about before.
Yeah.
As a well-behaved Doughboys audience member.
That's right, yes.
Because there's like a lot of idiots just yelling shit.
Hot salad! Do hot salad! Cool, do hot salad. Fuck do you want from us?
But then it will be weird. There'd be stuff that you don't know either. Like, okay. Cum bum. And you're like, what's cum bum?
Did we say cum bum on the podcast? No. I made it up. What?
What? Why are you doing this right now?
I paid $60 for this ticket. Cum bum. What are you doing? All right, play your drop, Mitch.
Oh, yeah. Emma, hit him with a drop. I don't even play it.
Okay. So curious when you're going to go, because live show, you really like to just...
I know, fuck. I kiss them and I love them, because to me they're all the same. I hug them and I squeeze them, they don't even know my name. They call me the... Panderer? I'm a panderer?
Yeah. I roam around, around,
around, around. Mitch, you got to be your own man. You got to be your own man. Four forks.
Wow. Oh, that was when I pandered to... Where was I pandering there?
That was DC, I think.
Oh, okay.
Tammy and Jamel?
Yeah. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. What was that chain?
I don't know.
The pizza place.
Oh, the pizza place. The place.
Oh,
that,
yeah.
That was not a four.
No, it was not a four. Forks. That was bad. That was a bad rating.
Yeah.
Bad rating. Hey, Mitch, Nick, Emma, Amelia, Casey, and the Drop King. When you asked if you were a panderer, the 1960s crooner Dion answered. If all goes well, the Chicago live show was a ton of fun, and you pandered to us with another shot of Malort.
Wow.
XOXO Leah, a.k.a. Chicago Leah from the Discord.
Wow, Chicago Leah, great to hear from you.
Wow, that's fun.
Yeah, that's a fan we like.
That is a fan we like. Probably stay pretty quiet at those shows.
Yeah.
Malort was bad.
Yeah, Malort was. Well, I don't mind it as much. But I also, like, we've had this before where we had Fernet, which Emma and I both enjoy. You did not like the Fernet.
I think
it's a similar
either.
Sort of,
yeah.
it's a more potent, more pine-sol-y Fernet, but it's the same sort of, you know, character to it.
A more pine-sol-y Fernet.
Yeah.
And you like that.
Well, I like Fernet. I don't know if I like Malort, but it's not as, like, noxious as some people think it is, to me.
Yeah. Malort sounds like a Madea catchphrase.
Our guest today, Lisa Gilroy, is here. Hi, Lisa. Thanks so much for being here.
Hi, the boys.
Wow, what a treat. Thanks
for
making time for us.
Oh, my God. Thanks for having me here at the Dough Factory. I'm a huge fan, Nick,
wow,
especially of your TikTok show, your Piss and Tell, where you
eat
the food and then you piss it out. I love it.
Thank you so much.
I like the idea of the dough, like a steam whistle going off and us having lunch pails.
Yeah, hard ads.
Coming in and... creating dog shit.
Right. Sliding down a dino's tail. Lisa, we have to address what you mentioned to us before we started, which is you were wearing a cake shirt on a day in which we were discussing cake, and this was an accident.
Yeah, I noticed in the car.
Wow.
I thought the boys are going to scream about this, and you have. So I'm satisfied.
We were very excited about it.
Yeah, they were, as soon as I walked in, they were hooping, hollering. They took off their own shirts. They fling them around their heads. They threw them into the office at large.
Yeah. We had to apologize to all the HeadGum staff working in an office.
And then they were like, please, can I wear it?
Like.
Please, can I wear it? Please, can I wear it? I said, no, you guys, this is my shirt.
Yeah.
Switch with me, switch with me, switch with me. God.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're pissed off. I'm sure that we wouldn't stretch your shirt out, your cake shirt.
Is this the band cake?
Yeah, I guess it's the band cake.
Oh, cool.
There was a...
You got a favorite cake song?
That's a great question. I like all their songs. That's the problem. I went to a cake concert recently and I was like,
whoa.
I was kind of like shocked. I guess I loved them my whole life, and then I went to the concert, and I was like, oh, this is my demo? Like, I didn't realize.
In what way?
I don't know. It just kind of had, like, a strange kind of vibe, like really, really pale men.
Oh,
I didn't
sure.
see a lot of women, and I didn't see anyone with, like,
a
tan.
To another cake concert, a.k.a. a Doughboy show. I think the audience would maybe be even more pale than a cake concert is.
I had a cake album, whatever the like their first big one was, and that was the only.
Oh,
that's
like
my,
the one with short skirt, long jacket on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's the only
Comfort
one
Eagle,
I know.
Comfort Eagle, I think that album's called.
But I did like it.
I love it.
I had a cake.
Your
album,
cake guy?
Let It Bleed. Isn't there a cake on that on the album cover?
Is there?
Oh, it had a cake on it. Had a cake. It wasn't Cake the Band. It had a cake on the cover.
Yeah.
Let It Bleed.
Nick's getting upset.
No, I'm just trying to. Oh, it's a Rolling Stones album. Yes, yes, yes. You are
there's
correct.
A cake on it.
Right? I love that song. Let it bleed. Let it bleed.
Lisa, I have a question for you.
What is it?
Gilroy, California.
Yeah.
Like your last name.
Yes.
As you may
asking.
Know, is the garlic capital of the world.
And my daddy is the king, which makes me the princess.
Whoa.
Yeah.
My question was going to be, do you like garlic?
I do like garlic, but I don't like, I like it. I don't want it to, I don't want my fingers to smell like it, and I don't want to have it raw.
Yeah, I get that.
Questions.
That's a great question, bitch. How dare you?
Yeah,
just tell her it's a Dracula test. We were testing
Dracula. We do a Dracula test here. We try to
Dracula.
Find. We do a Dracula
test.
It's
the Dracula vernacular.
It's another Madea catchphrase.
Well, it is kind of like bonkers that I said that I was part of like Gilroy family royalty, and then you like skip right past that, and you're like, do you like garlic?
Well, because I thought that was a bit.
It wasn't a bit. And now you feel
a
fool. No,
yeah,
it was a bit.
It's a bit.
It was a bit, but you could
acknowledge it.
It was a bit, but it was bait, and you could have bit.
See, oh, yeah.
This is my issue with them, too.
I don't know. I was fucking steamrolling towards my do you like garlic question.
Hey,
so.
Hey, question for you.
Yeah.
Do you like garlic?
I do like garlic. But same thing. I don't like it on my fingers.
Okay, now we're rolling. Now the podcast is cooking.
Yeah,
what about
good.
You, Mitch? Do you like garlic?
I only like it on my fingers.
Oh, a nasty boy.
I'll do the gloves sometimes if I got to do like a little garlic cutting because I just like I can't handle the stink on my hands for a while.
You have
yeah.
gloves for garlic under the sink?
I mean, not yeah. I mean, they're in the kitchen. Yeah.
Dracula at the proctologist is like, "There's no garlic on your finger, is there?" Yeah. He'd explode. He would, you know,
he'd explode.
He'd explode.
You are you kind of equating garlic to like how Dracula, when he sees sun, he turns to dust? Do you think?
Garlic is a thing that Dracula can't. He hates it, right?
I think he hates it.
He
it repels
it's yucky.
Him. Yeah.
But I don't think funny.
That's a funny monster. That is a funny monster. I think if he ingested garlic, I think it would maybe get him, right?
Maybe just make him really sick.
Yeah, I don't know what the origin of that is, you know, and I don't know if that's in the Bram Stoker canon or if that's something that was added later to vampire lore. Mm. But yeah, I think the idea is it just generally repels him. I'm also thinking my most recent comparison of garlic and Dracula's is the game Vampire Survivors, and you get the garlic there and it gives a little bit sort of like a protective orb around you.
That's, I think that's maybe more what it is.
Yeah.
It's the protective.
Kind of wards them
off.
So
they can smell it from a mile away, and no vampire's ever going to eat garlic, so we won't know the like gastrological effects of it.
Yeah.
Because he'll smell it from a mile away. You can't sneak it into spaghetti sauce for a vampire.
No, I don't think so. Do Dracula's eat at all? I don't know if they do.
They eat blood.
They eat the blood of virgins.
And maybe not. If you've had sex once or twice, they'll still eat your blood.
Yeah.
It's only once or twice.
But they can taste every sexual right. partner you've had. Yeah.
Was there a movie where like a Dracula eats garlic and like melts or something? Or no?
I don't know, man.
Someone shoot garlic into a Dracula's mouth?
That sounds like the Leslie Nielsen Dracula movie. I think this is
like Monster Squad. There's something.
Oh,
isn't there
Monster
something
Squad.
Where someone gets garlic in the mouth and then they melt or something?
I'm kind of getting obsessed with the way you say garlic. You're kind of putting like a flourish on the R.
Garlic.
I think what it is it's your Boston accent you're trying to overcorrect for it. Because you normally would
you
not
say garlic.
Yeah.
Oh, that might be what it is.
Yeah.
Garlic. You reminded me of the Flintstones when you said we would ride down the tail.
Yeah.
So I did this talk show where, you know this. Did I ever talk about this on the show?
I don't know.
Where I did this talk show where I wouldn't know what was going to happen. And they're like, we're taking you to the set of a new movie. I've told this.
What's going on with Mike Mitchell?
Oh, yes. Okay. Yeah. I've heard about this.
And they're like, we're taking you to the set of a new movie. And then they're like, what do you think it is? I was like, X-Men. And then they took my blindfold off and it was a porno.
I know this bit.
Yeah. Yeah. Which porno was it? I don't know.
It was XXX-Men.
They pulled the blindfold off and like two people were doing it. Like
right in front of you?
Like 5 feet away from me.
Is that like sexual harassment to you? Like, it's kind of strange, right?
Yeah.
To be like, haha, look.
Yeah.
Right.
Because you already said today that sex scares you and you haven't had a lot of it. So that's kind of a mean prank.
Well, hold on a second.
That's kind of like a haunted house for Mitch. That's not really fair.
It was wild. I had no issues with it.
How close were you to the action?
I was really close. And then they had me hold like a boom mic later. But when I was done.
What were you booming? Dialogue or like?
You know what he was doing.
Slurpy sounds, yeah.
Slurper.
There's a dirty story I can't even tell, which I've never told in the podcast, which I can't tell, which I think.
Okay.
I'll say it off air.
Yeah.
But
you can't tell because it's too dirty or because you signed an NDA?
It's too off. It's like gritty. Hard. I mean, like the whole experience is kind of hard, but.
I think I know the story. This guy was like having sex for a while, right? And then like some white stuff like came out of his wiener.
What the hell?
It was freaking nasty.
That's fucking sick, man.
And you're
like, is that piss? He's like, no.
Oh, is that white piss? No.
Did you drink a lot of milk earlier? Like, no.
That guy, this is why I brought it up, gave me a Flintstones XXX porn parody DVD.
Oh, wow.
Well,
okay.
He was in the guy who I was like booming was in the Flintstones.
So you agree, you did boom a guy.
I boomed the guy. And he gave me the Flintstones, but I was thinking of that, and I like you know, like, hey, it's a living, you know what I mean? They should have had like a bit where like a dinosaur or something was like sucking a dick, or
and he's like, it's a living.
Yeah.
What was it called?
The Flintstones XXX parody.
What a nightmare title! It could be like Fred and Wilma go bam bam, or like Rock Hard,
yeah,
or like pitch.
The Flint Bones,
sure.
Yeah,
pitch.
Yabba Dabba Goo.
Yeah, Yabba Dabba Goo is what we're lined up to see.
They stopped. No, they used to have like punny porno titles,
yeah.
And then sometime at some point in the past 20 years, they went to just like not blank a XXX parody. They just completely took the fun out of it.
Not
I guess because they
blank?
Spelled. Yeah, it'll
like,
be
not
like
The Simpsons.
Yeah, not The Simpsons at Triple X parody. And The Simpsons porno parody might just be called that, actually.
There really is one. Is it live action?
Yeah, and they got fucking yellow body paint.
No way.
Except on their
like
junk.
Homer fucks Lisa or whatever. It's like, you're like, why?
Don't say that. Why
but I'm just
say
saying that that's what happens.
Why would you freaking say that?
That's I'm just saying what happens in these things. Disgusting. These sick
God.
Things. But they should have had like a bird like sucking Fred Flintstone off saying, like, hey, it's living. Like, they should have.
That would have been fun. Here's the thing about The Simpsons porno parody.
Mm-hmm.
I think they just were like, didn't know the show all that well, because there's Homer and Marge in it, and Homer is actually the camera operator.
I can't believe I just randomly said the title of a porno parody and you've seen it.
Yeah, I've seen most of it. Anyway. there's like Moe in it, you know, like Flanders is in it. Homer is the camera operator from his POV, which is a weird choice. But actually the person doing the voice impersonation of Homer is pretty good. But like Marge is in it, okay. And then you think like, oh, who else? I bet Maude Flanders is in it. Helen Lovejoy, like, you know, who else? No, they have Cookie Kwan from the episode, the real estate episode, number one on the West Side. And then the other character is McBain's wife. Not in The Simpsons. They like made a new character. Of all the characters available for you in The Simpsons canon, famously a show with so many characters, they create McBain's wife out of thin air.
Maybe The Simpsons will copy from that parody and create McBain's wife. That's fun. McBain's wife.
Yeah, McBain's wife.
How was the porno?
It's gross.
Remember that? It's gross.
Here's the thing. So, like, it's like they have yellow body paint, right?
Oh,
but
right.
They can't do it on their genitals because
it's mustard and it would hurt.
It's mustard, yeah. And they say repeatedly, they're like, this is mustard. Like, don't get any mustard on you, which really breaks the fourth wall.
Right. But their eyes are watering.
Exactly.
This stinks. Spicy.
So you're just looking at, like, distinctly pink and brown genitals versus, like, a yellow body. And it's just like, this looks nasty. This is disgusting.
So
you would have liked it better if the genitals were yellow?
I think just some consistency. Or right. Just don't try to do yellow body paint. Just
or maybe like, don't try to make The Simpsons have sex.
Yeah, maybe you don't need to make The Simpsons live action porno parody. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what would be good for Flintstones? Remember in the movie how they had that sink pig under the sink and he was like a greasy little thing that would eat anything you gave him?
Yeah.
He'd be a good dick sucker.
That would be.
That's the guy who said he should say it's. You know, I never watched it. I think I re-gifted it to my mom for Christmas. But I should watch it and see if there is. Maybe they do that. I never watched it after I got it. I should have watched it. But it's only the right thing to do when you're
Well, now you can't watch a DVD. How are you going to watch that?
That's a good point. Maybe can I? Oh my! Does the PlayStation plays Blu-rays and DVDs or
yeah.
No? Okay, all right.
You can play DVD on that. I told you before. I don't know if I told this on my pod. My brother for my birthday 1 year got me Edward Penis Hands, porno parody of Edward Scissorhands.
And were you so pissed because the genitals weren't the color of knives?
Yeah, it's a real issue. Kind of took me out of it. That one's also gross. Let's talk a little bit about Alberta, which is where you're from.
Speaking of penis hands.
Yeah. We've been up to Canada. I've never been to Alberta. I've been to Saskatoon and I've been to Vancouver.
Okay, brag.
Yeah, and I'm curious, though, like, are there any distinct Albertan chains or, like, Canadian chains in general, fast food restaurants?
Oh, that's a good question. It's hard for me to tell because when I came here, mm-hmm. I just, like, assumed that everything is American. Like, I feel like we get so much stuff from you guys.
Interesting.
That, like, when I know a song that's Canadian and Americans don't know it, I get really confused, or, like, a word. We have different words, as you know.
Yeah, sure.
But we have different, like, dessert. Like, we have you ever had a Nanaimo bar? That's kind of like a distinctly, well, that's from Nanaimo, BC, but Alberta's right next to that province, so we get Nanaimo bars. It's basically like a slab of butter with a layer of fat on some nougat and then some more butter and then chocolate and then buttercream and like something that looks like hollandaise sauce and then more cream and then butter.
Wow.
I don't think we've had these before.
No, we've had some Canadian treats. A lot of our friends have sent them to us, but I don't
Is
know if we've had
that we've like tried on the live
Meat
show.
Square, did you have?
Well, maybe that sounds familiar.
That sounds more familiar. Yeah. Yeah.
That's kind of like a Rice Krispie treat, but it's puffed wheat and it has chocolate and molasses on it.
That does sound more familiar.
Yeah, it does sound more familiar, but I can't remember distinctly.
Those are kind of like the big hits. And at Starbucks in Alberta, you'll get a puffed wheat square. Like, that's what you would get.
Wow.
So it's like kind of shocking to come here and have the Starbucks not have that.
Like, it would be a thing like behind the counter. You
yes,
can order,
it would
like,
be like next
pop.
To the little cinnamon buns and the cake pops and the muffins.
That's fun.
Regional.
Yeah. I'm into that.
I've been to Montreal, so I've been. You've never been to Montreal, right?
Mm-mm. Bonjour, and no bonjour to you.
Fuck.
And I had a. What is it? What is the smoked meats up there? I loved it.
Oh, like a doner?
But I've had doner like up poutine? There too.
A specific restaurant you're thinking of?
No, it's like I think it's smoked meats. Montreal. Hold on, I'm gonna look.
Montreal
it up.
Smoked meats.
Yeah.
Wait, but smoked meats the concept, or it's a restaurant called smoked meats?
No, it's that's the concept. Yeah, smoked meat. It is. It's like pastrami, basically.
Oh, the name of the dish is smoked meat.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
Okay, I just thought that was universal.
There it is. Montreal smoked meat.
Got it.
We have Orange Julius, too. That's a chain. Wait, do you have it here?
We do have Orange Julius.
Okay.
Yeah. Almost not anymore.
Orange Julius, I think, actually from Southern California. Remember, we covered it.
What?
We covered it with Aukerman. I think it's originally from SoCal.
Oh, I'm thinking it's a Canadian thing because it has we have the biggest orange in Canada, and it's just in front of an Orange Julius.
Oh, that's cool. Like the big donut outside on top of Randy's Donuts?
Yeah,
like
a
big
I can imagine it's something similar to that.
Wow.
And we also have a giant, I just got made fun of on another podcast for saying this wrong. In Alberta, we say kubasa. That's what the sausage is called.
Okay.
And you guys call it kielbasa?
Oh, kielbasa. Sure. Yeah.
So we have a giant kiel. Say it again.
Kielbasa?
Kielbasa.
Yeah.
Garlic. we have a giant statue of that, too.
Wow, that's cool.
Yeah.
Kielbasa, you think of it this way. Kill.
Yeah.
Someone, and then... what do you think for bossa? Bossa
Nova.
Like bossa nova or boss nass.
Boss nass, and then add an A.
Yeah.
You know who boss nass
no.
is?
No.
I think bossa nova is cleaner.
Yeah, bossa
is
nova
boss is. Boss nass, that's the nasty little pig under the sink in Flintstones.
It's kind of similar.
Who is it?
He's the leader of the Gungans.
Leader of the Gungans on Naboo.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of the underwater species.
Leader of the Gungans on Naboo.
Yeah, the planet Naboo.
After the initial...
You guys are pissing me the hell off. What's happening?
After the initial attempt on...
Is this another porno parody that I don't know about?
On Princess Amidala, he holds up a big
orb.
Queen
Amidala.
Queen Amidala.
Oh, I know her. Okay, now we're in Portman territory.
Yeah. So Queen Amidala's there, and she, like, kind of like the Gungans kind of cohabitate with, like, you know, the people who, the land dwellers on Naboo.
Mm-hmm.
And how did we get here? What were we talking about?
How did we get here?
Oh, Bossa.
Kielbasa.
Okay, so Bossa is Queen Amidala's little brother.
Yeah, but this is the thing. It's Boss Nass, and there are many bosses, so I don't think it's a mnemonic device saying Kielbasa Nass.
Oh, you're
Nass
actually saying Boss Nass.
Boss Nass. Yeah, so, Bossa Nova, I think, is cleaner.
Okay. Because it is actually the word.
It is
Boss
actually
Nass,
the word.
You have to add the A and then drop the Nass.
And then drop the Nass. And then you're like, who's white Bossa? Oh, Boss Nass? What?
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't really work as a nickname.
But for us, it maybe works more.
It maybe works
we
more.
Like, we are big fans of Boss Nass.
Yeah.
Right. And now I am, too.
Yeah.
He seems simply irresistible.
You know who I like? And I always forget the characters' names, because there's Jar Jar, and then there's Boss Nass, but then there's, like, that third Gungan. Who like is like a primary Gungan, but he like
the guy who has the mustache.
He's got the mustache,
yeah,
he's like take him this one. He like throws like Jar Jar a bomb.
Yeah,
like, that guy's fun. He's like a little less annoying than Jar Jar.
Yeah, he's kind of a little bit more serious. He's a more serious Gungan.
Yeah,
this is before the Clone Wars. How do I describe this?
What do you think I bing? Prominent Gungans? How do I find out which guy this guy? This
I think was? Prominent Gungans would right, work.
Prominent Gungans.
So you guys like Jar Jar then? I thought everybody hated Jar Jar.
I've come around on Jar Jar.
The tide's turned on Jar Jar.
The tide's kind of turned. I mean, we like Ahmed Best, who's the actor. You know, I think he did a great job, and it's just like a kind of a trailblazing performance in terms of motion capture and voice, you know, as one.
There's also this theory that Jar Jar was a Sith.
Jar Jar was a Sith, yeah.
No fucking way.
Jar Jar was one of the bad guys the whole time.
Whoa. Sith is how British people say sixth.
I find a lot on Jar Jar, not a lot on that other guy. Who's that other Gungan?
January Sith.
Yeah. If Sith.
Yeah, this is just about Qui-Gon.
Qui-Gon Barobla?
We'll give him time. He should look this up.
You know, we'll find it out. I'll say, Boss Nass promotes Binks to the position of Bombad General. So remember that, Bombad General Jar Jar. But who the fuck is that other guy? You know what? Let us know in the comments. You want to do hashtag Mystery Gungan and send us a name and maybe a Wikipedia link. We will distribute that to everyone. But I
have you guys been to the Galaxy's Edge?
No, I haven't. Mitch has.
Got him.
You got him?
Yeah.
What is it?
It's I'm looking it up right now. Oh, I mean, like I got him on here. I mean, this is him.
Yeah, that's him. Yeah,
oh, yeah, that's his.
Got a catfish look.
I just his name is Roos Tarples.
Roos Tarples. How could I forget?
There he is.
Okay, will you guys give me two names that exist in the Star Wars universe and one that you're just making up on the spot, and I'll try to guess.
Okay,
that's fun.
But you can't be any, like, here are the names that I know. Jar Jar. So don't use that one.
Okay. Let's see.
Mace Windu.
Okay.
Okay.
Darth Plagueis.
And one more.
Kit Fisto.
Kit Fisto? Darth Plagueis? What was the first one?
Mace Windu.
Mace Windu seems real because Nick immediately was like, mm-hmm. Like, classic.
Oh, yeah. Must include. Yeah, I forgot. That's what we were doing.
Kit Fisto sounds like the mix of, like, kittens and fisting, which we were just talking about.
Oh, my God.
So I'm going to say you made up Kit Fisto.
Actually, all three are real. No. We
gotcha.
Tricked you.
We tricked you.
You fucking suck. This was the one way for me to be included in this conversation.
We tricked you. We gave you three actual names from the Star Wars universe.
Oh, they're all real. What's his name?
Kit Fisto?
No, the other guy. Tarples.
Oh, yeah. Roos Tarples?
Roos Tarples. Roos Tarples.
Yeah.
All right, I can remember that.
Roos Tarples.
Can I ask you specifically about A&W Canada? Because that's one of the best chains that we've ever, like, visited on the road.
I color orange.
Is there no A&W in America?
There is A&W in America, but there was a schism at a certain point. They have completely different, like, corporate ownership. The north of the border and south of the border, yeah.
Oh.
They're completely different companies with the same branding.
Well, okay, so then it must be all the same, like, root beer is most famous.
Yes, yeah.
What's chuckling over here?
I mean, I don't know if we can, I mean, all right. I was reading the Roos Tarples. I mean, this is funny.
Okay.
I was reading the Roos Tarples Wikipedia.
Uh-huh.
I was like, Roos Tarples was a Gungan male who served in the Gungan Grand Army during the invasion of Naboo. And then there was an ad below it.
It says, am I gay?
It's an am I gay
test. Just a quiz?
It's like, am I gay quiz on her.
We'll have our results right after this break.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Spoon Man, and I want to talk to you about today's sponsor, Helix Sleep. You know I love my Helix mattress. And in fact, Wags, I just recommended it to someone who's very special in our life. Not the special person who's waving to me out the window as we do ads, you song. But someone else who's very special in our lives. Super producer Emma Erdbrink.
That's right.
Emma now has a Helix mattress. I love my Helix mattress. It's comfortable. It's like sleeping on a cloud. I got the Moonlight Lux Wags.
Wow.
Know who loves it? Me. My mom. I don't sleep in the same bed. She goes in there by herself.
Mm, sure.
Wally and Irma.
Mm-hmm.
We all love my Helix sleep mattress.
The Helix lineup offers 20 unique mattresses, including the award-winning Lux Collection, the newly released Helix Elite Collection, a mattress designed for big and tall sleepers, and even a mattress made just for kids. So how will you know which Helix mattress works best for you and your body?
I'll tell you how, Wags. Take the Helix Sleep Quiz and find your perfect mattress in under 2 minutes.
And your personalized mattress is shipped straight to your door free of charge.
Helix knows there's no better way to test out a new mattress than by sleeping on it in your own home. That's why they offer a 100-night trial and a 10 to 15-year warranty to try out your new Helix mattress. Everybody's unique, and everyone sleeps differently. That's why Helix has several different mattress models to choose from, each designed for specific sleep positions and feel preferences.
Models with memory foam layers to provide optimal pressure relief if you sleep on your side.
Bottles with more responsive foam to cradle your body for essential support in stomach and back sleeping positions.
Plus, enhanced cooling features to keep you from overheating at night.
I need that, Wags. Keep me cool, baby.
And if your spine needs some extra TLC, they got ya. Every Helix mattress has a hybrid design, combining individually wrapped steel coils in the base with premium foam layers on top. It's the perfect combination of comfort and support.
Not only is the mattress the best I have slept on, but the setup was fast and easy. It came right to my door, Wags. Helix mattresses are all delivered in a box and straight to your door for free.
Plus, Helix mattresses are American-made and come with a 10- or 15-year warranty, depending on the model. Don't want to take our word for it? Helix has been awarded the number one mattress picked by GQ and Wired magazine. It is even recommended by multiple leading chiropractors and doctors of sleep medicine as a go-to solution for improving your sleep.
Wags, Emma's a convert. I'm a convert. Micus is a convert. Get
wow,
your Helix
Micus.
Sleep mattress. Helix is offering up to 20% off all mattress orders and two free pillows for our listeners. Go to helixsleep.com/doughboys. This is their best offer yet, and it won't last long. With Helix, better sleep starts now.
This episode is sponsored by BetterHelp. You know, Mitch, as the end of the year approaches, I'm looking forward to the holidays, but also, like a lot of people, struggling with some SAD, some seasonal blues. This time of year can be a lot, and it's natural to feel some sadness or anxiety about it.
Oh, oh, oh.
Well said. But adding something new and positive to your life can counteract some of those feelings. Therapy can be a bright spot amid all of the stress and change, something to look forward to make you feel grounded and to give you the tools to manage everything going on.
Wags, I know that when I am in therapy, I'm a better person. I get the gunk out, I'm feeling good, anxiety goes away. I feel good. You know what? I feel like it's time for me to get back into therapy.
It's helped me and it's helped a lot of people that I care about, including you. It's helpful for learning positive coping skills and how to set boundaries and empowers you to be the best version of yourself, and it isn't just for those who have experienced major trauma. So if you're thinking of starting therapy, give BetterHelp a try.
It's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to get matched with a licensed therapist and switch therapists at any time for no additional charge.
Find more balance with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/Doughboys today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/Doughboys.
Ho, ho, ho!
Welcome back to Doughboys discussing Milk Bar with our guest Lisa Gilroy. Lisa, before the break, we were talking about A&W Canada, and we got derailed, but yes, we talked about
deranged.
The Burger family. We did get a little deranged.
Yeah, we did.
I want to interject.
Okay.
I clicked on the Am I Gay test, and I want to share with you the first question.
Okay, great.
The first question of the Are You Gay test, the first question is, do you think you are gay?
Wow.
Is that the only question?
I mean, there's 20 questions.
Wow.
I've genuinely never clicked on an ad.
It's already like it's taking me off site. Like It's like already it's already not a good.
Second question is your social security number gay? Prove it. Put it here.
Oh wait, no. All right, so the questions were below. Have you ever been intimate with someone of the same sex? Okay, so I mean like This isn't very much like the quiz I thought it would be, I guess.
Yes, right.
He's answering.
Have you ever questioned your sexual orientation Have you ever questioned your sexual orientation before taking this quiz?
All right, stop taking the Am I Gay test on air.
All right, fine. I won't take it on air.
You're still taking it.
I know, fine. It's fine. Fine, I won't take it.
The one thing they have in A&W Canada, first off, the food is just a much higher quality than it is here. But the burger family, that's a thing. Like I don't think we have that at A&W down here.
I can't believe that's like A&W's signature thing: Mama Burger, Papa Burger,
yes,
Baby Burger,
Uncle
baby
burger. I think there's an Uncle Burger.
Uncle
there might
burger.
Be a Baby Burger,
Stepdad Burger, Newborn Burger, Dead Grandma Burger. Teen burger, that's always what I used to get. Well, that's the thing. It's like, you know, when you are growing up in Canada, I guess, you have to, like, identify with who you are in the family. So I had teen burger when I was a teen because I thought, like, this is what I'm meant to be doing. What am I going to order? Grandma Burger? No.
No, you don't want to do that.
Why go order the preteen burger that kicked him out of the restaurant?
All right. the original lineup consists of, there is a baby burger.
But that sounds like really bad to say, don't you think?
Yeah.
Baby burger, like
baby
what's
burger
the meat?
Sounds.
Yeah, it does sound when you think break it down that way. Like, but it does make sense meat? In terms of its size because it is the smallest. But yeah, the original burger family lineup is baby, mama, teen, and papa, and then they've added to that grandpa,
yeah,
uncle, and double teen.
Ooh, that's double that hot ass bouncy little titty teen. Bounding through the door. Why doesn't grandma get a burger? What the hell?
I don't know why there's no grandma burger.
Grandma has Alzheimer's. She forgot to get a burger.
All right, I gotta stop. I'm still taking the quiz. I gotta stop taking the quiz.
Have you ever eaten a double teen burger? Milk Bar was founded by Christina Tosi, who was the pastry chef at David Chang's Momofuku. In 2008, she pitched converting an adjacent space in their East Village location into a bakery, which they did into Momofuku Milk Bar. They Sean Parker'd away the Momofuku. Now it's just Milk Bar. Their signature dessert is the Milk Bar Pie. It's where they put them on the map, as we were discussing beforehand, Mitch. And it was known as Crack Pie until 2019.
Okay, wait. Guess which one of these three is the Star Wars name? Tosi, Momofuku, or Jar Jar?
Blind, I might guess Momofuku. Mm.
They're all Milk Bar names, you fucking
wow.
idiots. Jar Jar is for the jar of
it's
jam that
jars.
They sell. Yeah. It's two jars of jam.
Crack Pie until 2019. It's an oat cookie crust filled with a custard made from butter, egg yolks, milk, and sugar. So it's akin to a chess pie. Now, I've been to Milk Bar. There are 11 locations. The one I've
police.
Been to.
The woke police.
That's right.
That kicked in the door of Milk Bar and said that Crack Pie is now, what is it now?
Milk Bar Pie.
Milk. That sucks.
Well, let's talk about it. Because, like, crack.
Yeah.
It's a drug.
Crack is a drug. Is a drug.
Yeah.
So...
I talk about this in my talk about this in my intro a little bit, but it is like a thing. Like
I understand
why they changed it.
Yeah. I willingly smoked crack one time.
Wait, really?
I was really fucked up, and I was with friends, and they were. I was.
I don't think you were with friends.
That's a good point.
And I was like, what is that? And they're like, it's crack. And I was like, give me that. I'll smoke it. I was like, the sun was up. I was all fucked up. And I smoked it.
How long ago was this?
And then this is when I was 21 or 22.
Okay, so you're very young.
And then the next morning, I was like, oh, my God, I smoked crack last night? You know, like, it was just like at like 4 p.m. the next day. And a guy was like, no, it was just weed. But so I made,
I made the conscious
decision to smoke crack.
So you smoked weed and thought it was crack.
I was beyond blackout drunk.
But what did you think? Was they just handed you a pipe, or did you see something that you thought resembled crack, the drug?
I don't know. I was out of my mind. So I took the step to smoke what I thought was crack.
Wow.
But I never did it. I never did again. I never smoked. I haven't smoked crack.
Sound like fucking Bill Clinton. You know?
I did inhale, but it wasn't crack. Man, Bill Clinton, I didn't inhale was for weed.
Yeah, I know. Isn't that wild?
That's crazy.
It's crazy.
That's a different time. So yeah, there are 11 locations of Milk Bar now. They're all in like, you know, kind of major cities, and they're kind of, I feel like it's kind of a touristy spot because I went to the Las Vegas one. That's my. My understanding of it, and this their flagship location in LA is on Melrose, and that's where we got our order from. Lisa, had you had Milk Bar before?
I think I might have had it once before. Well, actually, my sister has a Milk Bar cookbook, so she like cooks some things from it. Does that count?
Right.
But probably not. Doesn't
I think
have
so.
The doesn't have the Tosi touch.
But that's the thing. Like Tosi herself has become a brand now, in the same way that David Chang is like a brand. She's like a pastry, you know, celebrity. She has all these cookbooks and shit.
Half pastry, half celebrity. Scary. Don't get your legs wet, Tosi.
Joe Biden is 4 years older than Bill Clinton.
Isn't that wild to think about?
That's insane.
Yeah.
That's
crazy. Is he gay, you think?
I don't know. We should forward him the gay
test. Yeah, forward it.
He like releases a statement about how alarmed he is. Like when he saw Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning, he was like, we have to tackle AI. He's like, what?
Come on, man. Now,
our president saw a movie and was like, we got to take action.
And now in high schools, when I take SATs, you got to take the gay test too. that's what we're going to do. That's my Joe
Biden.
Biden.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, it also kind of sounds like Bill Clinton a little bit. Kind of sounds a little bit like Bill Clinton in there too.
Here's what I'll say about Milk Bar. This,
Nick, do you think it sounds a little bit like Bill Clinton?
I thought you were doing Clinton at first, yeah, but I wasn't going to comment on it because I wanted. I figured you might be doing
Biden's not far off, I feel
he's
like.
He's just less of a twang, like Southern
less
twang.
Less of a twang, yeah. Come on, man.
Milk bar. You know, yeah. We could all have a little bit of milk bar.
He's a little harsher. Talks a little harsher. A little bit
fucking
more.
Eat your yeah. milk bar.
Yeah. Clinton's a little bit more smooth.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking yeah. about.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a little smooth, like yeah. the saxophone.
I watched a video from his inauguration of just like, they got, at Clinton's inauguration, they got like all like the biggest American jazz saxophonists to like stand in a line, and they each did like 6 bars of solo.
Yeah.
And so it's like 20 saxophonists all going in a row, just like trying to give their like, you know, like most intense licks for like a very limited amount of time. 6 bars is not a lot to improvise with.
Sure.
Yeah.
You think they were improvising?
I think so, probably.
I would come with my very best notes ready to go. Everyone's going to go, she came up with that on the spot? No, I've been practicing it for years.
Yeah, that was good. Yeah,
was that 6 notes that you just did?
It was way more than that. But it was, well, how much?
Within
is
six bars. Within, like, it's not, that doesn't mean 6 notes. That means how many measures of.
Of eight.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's actually a long time. If there's a whole, if there's a lineup of 150,000 people with trombones, that'll take a long time.
That is a good point.
I used to play trombone.
Did you really?
7th grade.
That you're Whoa. Well, you know about him.
I don't know about him.
I did play saxophone. I also played clarinet and bassoon.
Bassoon. He was a bassoon guy.
Yeah.
Bassoon. God, bassoon. Americans are so fucked up that they let kids have bassoons. In schools? What the hell?
Yeah. It was I'm definitely in the wind instrument family, but these are
woodwinds. I would
definitely
be afraid seeing you with a long-ass bag coming into school. My bassoon. Don't worry, it's my bassoon. Every day.
It gets taken out before he even makes it to band class.
Was Sox the cat at all a part of the...
I don't know. Can you bring a cat to a fucking inauguration?
I don't know.
I think they'd be going crazy, right? Maybe if you put them in a crate.
In the Clinton porn parody, Socks the Cat should like suck him off and be like, it's 11.
Mitch, what the fuck? God.
Wait, you played trombone.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it? And was it just for 7th grade?
Yeah. Well, 7th and 8th grade. But okay. My teacher told me I'd never amount to anything because I kept reaching out and grabbing the bell. You know, like, so the 7th position on a trombone is like near the bell. And I kept touching it with my little fingers to feel where I was at. But you're supposed to just memorize where the positions are. Because there's no way that the slide doesn't stop at certain notes. You have to know where they are.
No, it's not like a valve brass instrument or a woodwind where you've got like discrete like finger positions. Yeah. It's like, yeah, it's all based on feel. It's like a biomolecule.
My band teacher was 5th grade, which is too early to give kids instruments.
Yeah, totally.
And I told you that
Too early?
You stuck it up your butt or what?
Sadder than that, I play.
Sadder than that?
I played.
Buckle up, brother.
I told Wise. I've said this on the show before. Yeah. But I played the Simpsons theme song for my grandparents.
Aww.
And I remember it's like, this is like the last few years of their lives. And it's me being like, pum, 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 like speaking the song into my saxophone.
You didn't know how to actually play.
You were singing it into the sax.
So it was like my grandparents who were like in like their last like year of life watching me be like.
Wait, is this a video you have?
No, it's just a very vivid memory of my 3 grandparents watching me play watch me play The Simpsons.
That's interesting that makes you sad. You're just sad that you played saxophone near them when they had only a few years to live.
I'm sad for, like, literally for one of them, it was a year. For two of them, it was about a year left of their life.
Don't you think it made them happy to see you play your instrument?
No, it sucked.
You think that's what killed them?
Possibly.
God. I think look at me. If I was your grandma, would love to hear you play.
She deserved a cooler grandson.
Oh, there's nothing cooler than playing the Simpsons theme song. What are you supposed to play? Edelweiss?
Your concern is that you
she
didn't actually
She deserved
play
a,
it.
A Mac Culkin grandson, and she got fucking...
Macaulay Culkin?
Yeah.
What, you wanted her to step on a nail and get a paint can swung at her head?
No, I don't want her actually going to the Home Alone house. I didn't want her to enter the Home Alone house. I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy.
I would.
I would never, you would wish, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy.
I just got a really good idea. Do you guys want to be my business partner? Say yes before I tell you what they
yes.
do.
Okay.
Yes, I'm in.
This Christmas, we do a Christmas
this is a great idea,
haunted
man.
House. And it's a Home Alone house where you have to enter and there's a bunch of like things going on that could hurt you. But it's like Halloween, but for Christmas. And if you're brave enough, you come through the Home Alone house. How fun!
It's funny, though, because, like, you can't really have a nail that they step on. It has to be, like, it has to be something that's like it. You know, like, it buzzes
you. It could be a buzz sound or something.
Oh, yeah,
somebody.
Why don't we just have a big fucking empty house, and you walk in, you'll hear a buzz sound?
Well,
People will love that.
I don't think you can hit someone in the face with a paint can.
I'm wrong to partner with you guys.
No, I think there are practical concerns.
You're too scared of creative ideas.
It's not a creativity thing. It's
if the paint cans were soft.
The safety issue.
And maybe it has some sort of buzz sound.
Okay, rethinking. You know how you can go to those things where it's like Instagram influencers take pictures, jumping into a pool of sprinkles? It's the Home Alone house, but the paint cans are plush, and you can pose with it getting hit on the side of the head.
That's
you
fun.
You can pose on the stairs.
Can we
your
put
foot
some? Can we implement some sort of buzz sound in there? You
sure,
know
there
can
be a fucking buzz sound. You want a buzz sound?
I mean that in both ways. We should get some buzz sounds. Sounds from buzz.
Sure, of course, yeah.
And then also a buzz, like if you step on the nail, there's a buzz. But then also sounds from buzz, like.
And buzz like.
Kevin, what'd you do to my room or whatever?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I wouldn't let you in my room if you were growing on my ass. Devin, you're what the French call les incompétents. That's what will be coming through the speakers everywhere you walk.
Devin Rattray, right? Isn't that his name?
Is it his name?
Is that a Star Wars character?
You know what I don't care for with the Wet Bandits is that what gives them their name, that they flood the house by turning it. Like, that's just so wasteful. I get that it's kind of their signature, but,
yeah, but
more, you're
what?
More aligned with the Sticky Bandits, eh?
Oh, yeah. That was at Home Alone 2?
That's Home Alone 2, yeah.
What they do that make it sticky? Don't say jizz.
I'm not going to say jizz, so I'm just not going to say anything at all.
Okay.
they have, like, taped hands. And then it's like, I think, like, Which one is Marv? Is Marv
the tall one? Joe Pesci is.
Joe Pesci is.
Wait,
I don't fucking know. I just know him.
I think Marv is Joe Pesci.
Marvin, what's the other one's name?
I only think of them as Joe Pesci
Harry.
And Daniel Stern.
Marvin Harry.
Yeah, Harry's the tall one. Marv's the little one. Joe Pesci
like,
is
Marv. Like, and then like, I think Marv is kind of like Harry. You idiot. You know what I mean? I saw a video the other day that Joe Pesci like made up his own language because he swears so much.
Yeah,
so that's
the part
why,
where he burns his hand on the doorknob. I saw that too. He goes, because
he wants to say like fuck shit. Like he wants to say fucking shit.
You know, I used to live on a three story walk up, and I had to take my groceries up, and heavy groceries. Right? Imagine me like carrying all the bags at once, and then when I put them down, my hand would be all crypt up, freaked up, with like a really dark line in the middle where all the groceries. And I would always go.
That's fun.
Yeah.
That's a thing, like I've got, especially like before good reusable bags, when you get like plastic grocery bags or something and to be carrying them a long way, like walking home, like,
that
yeah.
It hurt.
My,
they turn them into
would,
like that little
numb.
Rope.
Yeah. Like,
yeah.
Well,
what would you sound like when you do that?
I'd be like, rag up, fuck it, rag up, fuck it.
Cut, Joe, you said fuck on that one.
Right? Yeah, I can't do another one.
You said rugga shugga fucka shugga.
All right, I'll go again. Rugga fucka fuck.
Nope, cut.
Sorry.
That time it was rugga fucka fuck.
Sorry, it's hard. Okay, so we got
Joe Mac saying fuck around set. You caused Mac to say fuck around
Bob,
set.
I'm sorry. Like I did.
Mac saying fuck to Mike MJ now, and MJ's not liking it.
We don't tolerate that kind of language. Okay, the flagship Melrose store is where we got our food from. We got I'll run down the list of everything. We got a chocolate confetti cookie, a corn cookie, and a compost cookie. So that's the cookie trifecta. We got a chocolate bidet truffles 3-pack. So we got 3 of those. Those are like, you know
that's what they call us, the truffles party 3-pack.
Oh, man, I love that. We got a crunchy cereal milkshake and a chocolate bidet milkshake. And we got a birthday cake slice, a chocolate birthday cake slice, and a red velvet cheesecake slice, as well as their signature milk bar pie slice. Emma picked those up for us. Everything arrived in good shape, including the milkshakes, which we were worried about travel, but they were nicely. You had a nice little cooler there with some ice in it.
Yeah,
above
kept
and beyond.
Nice and cold. The only way to transport milkshakes.
So we got. So I feel like everything
Thank
we got
you,
was in its best state. I think we got stuff that was like we were able to try it how it's supposed to be, and you know, based on my prior
Those
milk
milkshakes
bar experience,
were thick.
They were thick.
They were not.
No, moving. They were not melted. No, they were. Everything was nicely intact. I'm not sure how I feel about this place. It's just so sweet. That's mm-hmm. the thing. I think I'm maybe just getting too fucking old, where just like that much sugar just to me is punishing. Like yeah. I'm like not having fun while I'm eating all this. I know this is not how normally people consume Milk Bar. They get like a slice of cake and maybe a shake and that's all they have. They don't have like nine things at once. But I don't know, even finishing like just one slice of cake here, I think would be too much for me.
Yeah, it's crazy. We are getting old, aren't we? I used to eat just sugar. Like, remember those like Pixie Sticks when you were a kid and you just like dump sugar in your mouth?
I did like those.
Or I used to make my special juice, which was just like a half a cup of sugar mixed with like a teaspoon of water. And it was like white sludge.
You call that my special juice?
Yeah. And my parents were like, what is that? It'll stop drinking that.
Seems very sweet from you, but if Weiger offered me my special juice today, I'd be horrified.
Have some of my special juice. Calm your nerves.
MJ, we're rolling.
Here's what I will say. Everything is well made and it's well packaged. Like, clearly they know that the bulk of their business or a lot of their business now is like delivery and takeout. So they have nice little containers for everything. It felt like it was all like, you know, this was the place executing these things how they're supposed to be. I'm sure they have. I assume you can have a little bit more consistency with a place that does desserts, that does baked goods when you're trying to scale up versus a place that's making like, you know, that's got like a flat top and a flat top grill and a deep fryer that's trying to make different dishes like on the go. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm assuming as someone who doesn't know a lot about these things, it's maybe a little bit easier to scale up that kind of industrial kitchen. So this resembles my experience at the Vegas one. It's just that, fuck, I don't know where to begin here. Mitch, what were your thoughts of this place?
You know, I've taken my experience with Milk Bar comes from when I would save up JetBlue points and I would sometimes fly Mint occasionally.
Uh-huh.
Mint chocolate chip.
And I'd save up, I'd buy a pint of mint chocolate chip. Uh-huh. That's what I call flying mint. Just eat the pint on the plane. Now, Emma, you'll know this. If you ever fly mint, they give you a Milk Bar cookie.
I only flew mint one time, and I don't remember what food they gave me, but I did eat all of it.
I had a JetBlue credit card, so I would save up points, and then I would do mint on the way back for like Christmas or something.
It's like their premium class.
It's like a premium class thing. Yeah. I know.
First class?
No, it's the same.
Pilot's lap?
It is pilot. It's pilot's lap.
Wow.
Which he did not like. I was crushing the man. They gave you a corn cookie sometimes, and then the two times I remember cookies is a corn cookie and then the compost cookie. Mm. And so besides that, I had Eva made a crack pie for us. Remember,
she
made a version of the crack pie, or sorry, the whatever it's called now,
Milk Bar pie.
But I didn't have a lot of experience with it, and it seemed kind of like a fancy dessert place. And I don't really care about like specifically dessert restaurants, but I know that they have a function. And I think that I maybe ordered a crack pie or something for like a Thanksgiving and people enjoyed it. But
it's a crowd pleaser.
It's all very sugary. Mm-hmm. But I know that like also it's a hard place to judge for us because we're eating like five desserts or we're splitting up five desserts.
And I know that's the thing I said earlier, but also I don't think any of us ate much more than the equivalent of like one piece of pie or one slice of cake or, you know, one to two cookies. Like we were having bites of everything.
Yeah.
We subbed up, like I had a quarter of three different cookies. So I had less than one cookie's worth of cookie, you know?
We were saying that I think this was kind of damning to the places that the thing that we enjoyed the most was the corn cookie.
Exactly. And they were a little more savory.
The corn milkshake, cereal milkshake.
For bread by the end of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're like, this one tastes kind of like bread. This one's corn. Yeah, and you were saying there was like a nostalgia factor too when you were having your shake, or one of you was saying like it's like the maybe it's just adults wanting to have cornflakes again.
I think that's what it, I think that's the appeal of the cereal, the crunchy cereal
that
milkshake.
That one milkshake is so much like just eating cornflakes in milk.
Yeah, it's
so
decidedly not sweet.
So it's almost the best thing you could get there if you don't want something too sweet.
Right.
Also, that red velvet with the cream cheese I thought was good.
The red velvet with the cream cheese is good. I question, does Milk Bar suck? And I don't think it sucks. I do not think Milk Bar sucks.
Yeah.
I think someone would have a dessert there and be like, this is a nice dessert. I'm happy.
If you brought, like, picturing you bringing that pie from the Milk Bar to the Thanksgiving, I'm like, you were a hero.
Yeah.
Because
that's fun. People see, he walks in, everyone goes, Rich. Like, there's something about, like, the logo is making it more delicious to me than it is.
Which maybe is a thing I don't like about it or something. Like, that's, like, maybe why I, like, in my head, I'm like, fuck this place. I mean, like, it was always for me when I would drive by it on Melrose or something.
You'd
like,
flip at the bridge. Fuck you.
Yeah, I say, fuck off. I mean, I don't want to go in that fucking place. Yeah. Do you, when you drive
it
by
looks
it?
So it looks to me as, like, delicious. Yeah. Like, the way the pink letters are and everything.
I think the branding is masterful. Yes. And I think that I think the logo is great. It's like a vibrant pink and white. And I think
masterful is just milk.
I think calling it Milk Bar. I don't know. That's a clever name. And I think also that extends to just how they name everything on their menu. I don't know.
Are they saying milk bar like how you could have a bar where it's a beer and you get beer?
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was like bar, like chocolate bar, but it's a bar made of milk.
No, I think it's like Milk Bar,
which is like a slice of cake.
Honestly, maybe it works on both levels.
Just want to clear things up. In the Star Wars universe, milk is blue. There's blue milk.
Yeah, I had that at Galaxy's Edge. Blue milk and green milk.
Did you? Yeah. The blue milk probably better, right, than the green milk. Were you a green milk guy or were you a blue milk guy?
I was blue milk.
I haven't had either. I haven't been to Galaxy's
Edge. You've never been to Galaxy's Edge?
No, I said that earlier on the podcast.
Dude, you
got to
hit up the Droid Depot. Yeah.
What's that?
You got to hit up the Droid Depot.
I'll go to the Droid Depot.
You might stalk this guy.
Build yourself a little droid. Yeah, you go there, you'll be king.
Fellow
droids, rise up.
Yeah, everyone there has seen the Simpsons parody porno.
have never been to Galaxy's Edge.
No. I haven't been back to Disneyland since the pandemic.
Wow.
I don't know. I haven't felt like I had a reason to go. Not that I don't like it, but I just...
You know my thoughts on Galaxy Edge.
What is it?
It's a little bit like what Jay Sherman would say. It stinks.
Stinks?
I think it stinks.
Stinks of what?
I think it sucks.
Did you like it?
I had fun there because there's a really good... The best ride, I think, is there.
Which one is that?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Rise of the Resistance?
Yes. You didn't like that ride? You were too fucking scared. Your eyes and plugged your ears the entire time. Kind of a review are we going to get out
of
this?
I'm not afraid of Rise of the Resistance. I'm not scared of the ride. Though I've been scared of my house just even hearing noises this week. I was not afraid of Rise of the Resistance.
And let it be known, I know I said this off pod before we started, but I want to say it here on the record. I think you have carbon monoxide poisoning. I just want to say that for when something your obituary shows up, it's floating around, and I could be like, I told everyone that.
You might be right.
Get it checked.
I do think that my smoke detectors do detect carbon monoxide, but you know, I might have slow carbon monoxide poisoning. I am feeling better being outside of the house. It's like going through a factory. It's like going through a factory to me. It's not fast.
What makes you happy? Gosh. Name one thing.
You said two things on this before. You said, how did we get here? And I was thinking, I was like, how did we get here?
Like existentially?
We get to this point?
Wow.
Whoa, you had like a thought about your life choices?
Yeah, like how did we get here? Shouldn't you feel the same way? Look at this. How did we get here?
Mitch is gesturing for people listening to this, Mitch is gesturing to our Doughboys logo, which is projected on our back wall here in the studio.
You guys love Star Wars. You got Darth Vader right here. Jesus.
Those are my cats, Wally.
He's one freaky dude.
Those are Wally and Irma, my cats,
really?
Above them. Yeah.
Aw.
Who hopefully are not suffering from carbon monoxide right now.
No, cats are immune.
And I know you're doing a bit, but that's wrestler Sting, just so. I know you're doing a bit, but.
Know it's Sting.
I know,
duh.
I'm just saying, it's
still
Sting.
Haven't found what I'm looking for.
No, it's okay. I know you're doing a bit, but. How do we get here? Is that what you're saying? How do we get to Doughboys doing the show, doing this shitty show?
We liked movies. We wanted to make movies and TV, and here we are. Look at this shit.
This is great.
Make this into a little animated series. You've pitched it before.
No, we haven't, actually.
Well, that's a really good idea, and let me connect you with me. I am now the head of Teletoon Network. Let's have a general after this, boys.
I'm into it. I don't know.
If the Doughboys thing we are able to sell is like Muppet Babies version of Doughboys, I mean, I guess it would be appropriate.
Or make it like Cabbage Patch Dolls, like for little girls, and they can get these little Doughboys, and they're one's inside a muffin, one's inside a donut. You open up whatever newborn baby you're going to find in there is your new little Doughboy. They don't make girls.
Honestly,
yeah, not a bad idea.
Good idea.
And it smells good. Did you guys ever have toys when you were little that smelled so good?
That's a great point. And I'm happy that you brought it up. We got to bring back the smells to toys. There's not enough. The smell factor is.
Listen, for my birthday, my sister got me a Barbie candle. It smells like Barbie's legs.
That's fun.
That rules.
Yeah, it's fun, you pervert.
Well, I think people like that.
Okay, it's cute when I say it. It's fucking weird when you guys like it.
What? I want the Barbie legs candle. That's all I'm saying. I want to smell Barbie's legs.
Barbie, when she comes out of her box, she smells like strawberries and cream.
That's
and plastic. And that's what the candle smells like. Sweet, sweet plastic.
Wow.
I remember there was, I wonder if you'll remember this. Because it's ancient. This is ancient. But they played like a Revenge of the Nerds on Fox. And it was like smell-o-vision. And you could smell along with the movie.
That
do you remember
can't be
this?
Right. It's, they squirted smell out of your TV?
No.
It was like a scratch and sniff thing
it was
you
a
got.
Scratch and
in the
sniff
mail.
Thing that you got. Yeah.
Oh, that's
yeah,
fun.
Yeah.
I don't remember with Revenge of the Nerds, but I remember this concept.
Yeah. Happening.
And they mail you like a scratch and sniff. So it would be like, what part? So in the movie, he's going to the bathroom. You can
it's
sniff
it's like
a
pizza.
Sniff.
And yeah, I mean, honestly, that it was more of that like level of like booger burped, like scratch. You know what I mean?
Ew,
you,
that's fun. We should do more of that kind of stuff.
That's what I'm saying. Smells. People are sleeping on the smell sense.
Smells are so. One time I was watching Gone Girl in theater. Do you guys remember when that movie came out?
Yeah.
I was smelling overwhelming smell of feet. Someone in the theater had taken off their shoes. It was the most disgusting smell in the world. Cheesy feet smell. And then I realized the guy in front of me was actually eating white cheddar popcorn. And then I was like, yum, actually.
That's like, it's like wild. What about your brain? Yeah.
That's fucking disgusting.
I was ready to throw up.
Yeah.
And then
when
I saw it was popcorn, I was like, I want some.
Yeah, that totally makes sense.
It smelled like feet. You must have been in a Quentin Tarantino movie.
Mitch.
He loves showing off feet. Mitch. I think
wait,
it's
wait,
sick.
Sorry, before you go any further, you know he's my stepdad.
Is Quentin Tarantino your stepdad?
Yes. You guys didn't know that?
That first of all, that would be insane.
Is this like the Gilroy thing?
Yeah, he's the step-prince of Gilroy, California.
This is what I'm saying. This is why I was flummoxed.
I think that he should show feet off as much as he likes. Yeah. I don't care about
you're so scared now that he's really my step-uncle.
No. I
you're
love Quentin
sweating,
Tarantino.
You're shaking. You're eating your words.
Weiger has heard me go off on this before.
Yeah.
I think the feet thing is bullshit. But I saw a David Fincher movie last night, The Killer.
I saw The Killer
last night. I liked it a lot.
I love The Killer.
And in Gone Girl, we had a big discussion about Gone Girl because you see Ben Affleck's hog.
Yeah, you do.
I said, it's ginormous. It's huge.
You see his dick in that?
Yeah, you see his dick in this movie.
I was so focused on that white cheddar popcorn, I didn't even notice. Wait, when's his dick in it? I don't remember that.
It's towards the end. I'll try to stay
it's
out of spoiler country.
It's just the end
country.
Of his dick?
Yeah. I'll try to stay out of spoiler country. There's a moment where there's a shower scene.
Oh, I remember. They're talking in the shower so that they can't be like recorded.
Yeah. Now
I'm trying to see if I have the video. I took.
Oh, this is not going to bode well for your am I gay test.
Here's the thing. You only see it in profile, but you do get a good look at it. Like, now you want to see it head on, but seeing it like you do get to get a sense of like what it's.
Capable of.
Yeah, exactly. Wow. Mitch thinks it's gigantic. Mm-hmm. I think he looks good, but I would not go that far.
Do you have a picture of it on your phone, Mitch?
I have the video of it somewhere.
Is that one of the questions on the test? Do you have a saved picture of the side profile of Ben Affleck's dick on your phone?
I'm searching hog right now, and I can't. And you're
searching hog? What?
Do you want me to search it? I'll search.
On your phone, you're searching hog in your phone.
I was
on the internet.
Ben Affleck.
I was searching hog. I was searching hog in my text messages.
Got it.
Oh, I tried to put Ben Affleck penis shower, but I forgot the ER and I just searched Ben Affleck penis show.
Well, should also work.
Yeah, it should maybe work. Look, I'm gonna see if I have it. It would be.
I'm getting a lot of blurred out images. This could be it. Oh, I found it.
You found it?
And it's a GIF or a GIF. Oh, look, I'll show you. Oh, yeah. This is exactly what we wanted. It's just replaying the moment over and over and over again.
And
he looks good.
That's fucking.
Yeah, always happy to see that.
Now
bad
that's
boy.
A teen burger. You know what I mean?
To quote Ron Burgundy, by Thor's hammer.
Yeah, it's pretty, it's a dangler, let's say.
Yeah.
But,
he looks good.
But, you know, in Sex and the City, they have, like, lots of fake dicks. I feel like the actors that have to show their dicks now are like, listen, I'm 60, I've been on this show for 100 years, I want the biggest dick, I want to go to the dick factory and pick my dick.
Yeah, I hate the fake dicks.
So, but this could
off.
Be a fake dick, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I don't think it's a fake dick.
I hate the fake dicks, you it don't pisses think me it's off. A fake is that dick? What you just said?
Yeah, I think he chubbed up a little bit, I think he knew he was going to be seen, so like, but you know, he's maybe showing himself a favorable light, but I don't think it's a fake dick.
Fake dick pisses you off, which is ironic, because fake dick can't piss.
Lisa, that's really great. I'm glad you said that. Yeah, because okay, so Wolf of Wall Street is one, right? Wolf of Wall Street, he has...
Actually,
Jonah
I'll
Hill.
Correct you. There are some fake dicks that do piss, actually.
Oh, sorry.
Wait, really?
Yours being one of them.
Yeah, there's. I feel like there is a...
Sure, you could put a sleeve on your dick, like a beer cozy or whatever.
Yeah.
Wolf of Wall Street, a movie with ample nudity, but Jonah Hill shows his dick in that movie, but it's a fake dick that he's jacking off. It's like a plastic dick, and it's just like, yeah, everyone else is being... Show your fucking dick. Jack off your real dick. What are we doing here?
Did you
here?
Get up and scream that in the theater?
I did, yeah.
Demand your money back?
When Jonah Hill got in trouble, Weiger went online, and he was like, yeah, and remember he didn't show his real dick in the movie?
We're up against the clock. We got to talk about.
Oh yeah,
up against the clock. Come on, I'm just joking around.
Okay, so starting in cake country, chocolate confetti cookie too sweet for me. Corn cookie I liked. I thought that was delightful. Compost cookie, I like the concept of it. It's just a cookie. It's like a kitchen sink cookie. Here's everything in here. It's fun. You don't really know what you're gonna get in any bite. Great textures. I thought that was fun. I thought that one and the corn cookie were the winners. Chocolate confetti I could do without.
Yeah, I mean, again, having the corn cookie after eating every other sweet, the cakes really just sugared me out so much that I was like, anything else I ate, like the cookies were affected by that I was just like, I'm so sugared out that the cookies are just tasting sweet to me. And then eating the corn cookie, I was like,
corn cookie was like a side of vegetables, comparatively.
Yes. It really was.
Eat your green beans before you can have your other stuff.
It was, and in that way, I liked it for that. I like the compost cookie, and I think the chocolate one was a little too sweet for me.
Yeah.
But the cakes, I think I would go with you on the red velvet cake. I think that's
Red velvet cake was the big winner there. Mm-hmm. I think you know what? I love birthday flavor. I actually think the regular birthday cake slice was not bad. I did like a little bit of crunch you get there from the sprinklies.
All the cakes chocolate were fine, birthday but having a quarter
cake was
of a
too chocolatey.
I thought it was okay, but having a quarter. We had three of those cakes. Just having a quarter of each of those cakes, which we didn't even eat the whole thing, it was like a whole slice of cake is way too much.
Exactly. Yeah. It makes me think, especially with a cake slice being $11, it makes me think that they're maybe designed for sharing, that you get one and or you're supposed to share it with. But then again, when you want to try multiple ones, so probably people would get their own slices. I don't fucking know. It was too much. I agree. But yeah, of those, I agree with Lisa's assessment that the red velvet cheesecake was the winner.
Here are the winners for me. Yeah. Red velvet cheesecake. The crack pie is good.
It is
enough.
Good. The milk bar pie. It's good.
And then corn cookie or the compost cookie. I don't know. Like the compost cookie, if I wasn't so sugared out and was just having one, I think I'd be okay with.
Yeah, like on the airplane.
Yeah, like on the perfect, mint when I'm flying mint.
Perfect time to have.
That's I think just one little treat.
I thought the birthday I wanted the birthday cake to be my favorite. I love also like you birthday flavor.
Yeah, I love birthday flavor.
The taste of balloons. But it was so sweet. It tasted like, you guys know Dunkaroos.
Yeah, I know Dunkaroos.
You guys
that
know Dunka?
That is a
great comparison.
That is a great comparison.
Every bite was just the icing part of Dunkaroo, which is like Dunkaroo is made glorious by the fact that there's the icing and the little cookie that you dip in it. You need like the balance. But the cake, it felt like every single bite was just a full mouthful of Dunkaroo icing.
Dunkaroos,
like there was no respite from it.
Dunkaroos, that's a great comparison. Dunkaroos, for people who aren't familiar, I think people know what they are, but I'm curious because we have Australian listeners, if Dunkaroos ever made their way over there. They came about during that era of American and I guess Canadian fascination with Australia in the 90s, and they were a kangaroo cookie that you would dip in icing.
This is an Outback. Dunkaroos are like Outback.
They're like Outback Steakhouse or Crocodile Dundee.
I never thought of those things. Yeah. Had a wave of Australian fascination.
Yeah, no, it was a big thing. What was the other thing? Young Einstein was the other one. Yahoo Serious.
Well, because we knew that Outback Steakhouses weren't in Australia.
They're not. No, they actually have made their way over there now, but they were founded in America purely as like, this is an Australian pastiche to cash in on the Australian trend.
So we're Dunkaroos, the other big thing from Australia, which is Outback and Dunkaroos.
Yeah.
And Boomerangs, I guess, is third.
Well, do you remember Crocodile Mile? Crocodile Mile was the ripoff. Yeah. I don't know if this was present in Canada, but there was a ripoff of the slip and slide called the Crocodile Mile. Yeah. And I wanted it so bad as a kid. And it was like ride the Crocodile Mile. And it was like a fucking slip and slide that
had
a crocodile.
It was genuinely a mile long.
I don't know if it was actually a mile
Parents were losing their kids.
It might as well have been for a kid because I was like, that looks
fun. Wasn't there a little pool at the end of
it? They had a pool at the end of it, yeah. And they had, I think they called it a lagoon.
Was the opening like a crocodile's mouth?
Yeah, they had like a crocodile-like thing that you would go through. And
hey,
then they had a boomerang bounce was part of it too, which I know in practice, if you were like going down a driveway, you would just like hit like whatever the bounce was.
Driveway,
and just, like,
you got to put it on a lawn.
Yeah, I know.
Your parents did not care for you.
Hey, who's slipping sliding on cement? That sounds horrible.
This guy.
Yeah, you're going to hit that boomerang bounce pretty hard either way, I think. Like, it's not going to actually propel you like it does.
This is all theoretical.
Theoretical. I never got to experience the fucking crocodile mile.
Was the slip and slide involving any sort of animal? Or is it just like a big tarp?
No, it's just like a yellow thing.
What was this? What was the one that was, you run, you slide, you hit the bump, and take a ride?
That, I think, is Crocodile Mile.
That's Crocodile Mile?
I think so.
I thought that would be an Australian guy.
I think he comes in, is like, ride the Crocodile Mile.
I don't know about this Australian guy. I don't know if he exists.
We used to sing a song at my elementary school about Outback Steakhouse. I don't know why. The children made it up. But we would sing, Outback Steakhouse is the place to go where the meat is grungy and the people are old.
Really good.
Why do you think we did that?
I don't know. It's a great song.
We had, and Weiger never knew this, but Emma, you did know it, was just Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut, Kentucky Fried Chicken and a Pizza Hut.
Never made
McDonald's. You don't know that?
That's the national anthem, bitch.
No, never encountered that as a kid. I didn't know it until you sang it.
Do you guys know fried ham, cheese and bologna? After the macaroni, we'll have mushrooms, peanuts, and pretzels. Then we'll have some more fried ham.
No, what the fuck?
What the fuck is that?
Canadian national anthem.
Wow.
That was I never heard that in my life.
Do you guys know this one? Funyuns, Fritos. Funyuns and Fritos. Gonna eat some Funyuns and Fritos. Crunchy corn snacks, Funyuns and Fritos.
This is bullshit. Funyuns
and Fritos. You don't remember that one?
This is bullshit.
You don't remember that one?
Is that bullshit?
It sounded real to me.
That's bullshit.
It feels real to me.
It was bullshit.
It was bullshit.
It was real to me. It was real to me.
The wrestling guy? You like that guy. It's still real to me, damn it.
That guy.
We like that guy.
He's leaned into his gimmick, too. He knows what he's doing. I think the shakes, to me, were duds. I don't need to get a fucking shake from
They're
here.
Duds, and now I have milk breath, basically.
Yeah.
Sure. I went full brush my teeth after that.
Oh, that's smart.
Well, my dentist told me I can't have sugar be sitting on my teeth.
Did you bring a toothbrush?
Yeah, I always have one in my bag.
You
and
always do?
Yeah, because my teeth... You know in Pirates of the Caribbean when they have that curse on them where they... the food turned to ash in our mouths.
Yeah.
My teeth are like that.
Ugh. Wait, really?
They'll crumble up to dust and fly away. Because I don't have a lot of enamel. That's why they're so white.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Because, you have some nice looking chompers. They look
pretty white.
Yeah, but
thanks. They're healthy. They look nice on the outside, but they're so weak.
Oh, wow.
Why did I just tell everyone that on a podcast?
I feel like my teeth like look kind of gross and yellow.
They're
but
strong,
they're also...
though. Enamel is what makes teeth yellow.
But they're not, though. They're like, they also
have you
get
tried
a lot of
punching
cavities
them out?
And shit. I haven't.
Try.
Yeah, all right. I'll get fucking punched in the face.
I used our costumes, you know, like the peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah.
And I dressed up and I watched scary movies over at Neil Campbell's house and Alan's son was there. I guess I shouldn't say his name.
Say it.
Maybe we'll bleep it.
Don't dox his son.
All right, I won't dox his son. Yeah. It's fine.
Say it where he lives and what his birthday.
But I was dressed as like a jelly piece of bread.
You mean Jar Jar? You were peanut butter and Jar Jar?
I was peanut butter and Jar Jar.
Jar Jar of jam?
Oh, shit, that would have been good. Because I wore the hat. I kind of put together a... Wags, I put together a thing of like I put on the shark hat that we wore from our...
Is it Wags or is it Wigs?
Could
be a
Wigs.
New nickname. I'm dying to say Wigs.
Yeah. Wigs is kind of cool, especially with his long hair. He used to have short hair. I don't know if you know.
Didn't we all?
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Everyone's born with short hair.
It's true.
Alan's son kept biting. He was just like biting at the gel. Like he was.
That's really cute.
Yeah.
That's adorable.
Fucking hurt. Bit me a couple times.
Well, he was doing it as a joke though, right?
Yeah.
As
I was bit. Fucking pissed off. Little kid pissed me off. I was gonna fucking.
Hey.
I was gonna kick his ass.
Mitch shows up with two black eyes. Alan's son beat the shit out of me.
We are at the age where I do wonder when that will happen. Like
when you get beat up by a child?
I said that to Ferguson. I was like, when do you think your son is going to be able to kick my ass? Because like the day you think he's old enough to kick my ass, I should come over and like box him. I think that's fun.
Yeah, that is fun.
Yeah, but it's going to happen soon.
Yeah, that's so true.
Yeah.
Because like a 16-year-old could probably kick your ass.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Definitely. The right 16-year-old for sure. Yeah. No, that's the one I would hate to get my ass kicked by a teen. I don't want to get my ass kicked by a teen as a grown man.
Yeah, I feel like I'm at the age, like speaking of sugar not being hitting as hard as it used to and actually just feeling bad, I'm also like afraid of teenagers now.
I think I've been afraid of teenagers my entire life.
Even when you were a teen burger?
Yeah, I think so. Whoa. I think even when I was a teen burger, it was like other teens are like, stay, you know,
wow,
gonna be bad news.
I agree with you. A teen's always a little bit scary.
Teens popping bubblegum, muddy boots in the house, Walkman,
right.
Listening to their music so loud, backwards hat, skateboard under their arm.
Yeah.
That's scary shit.
Yeah.
That's scary stuff.
Yeah.
What were we talking about? The food?
Let's take a break. We'll come back with our fork scores
we're gonna take
right
a break
after this.
Now. Oh, fuck. Okay.
Mitch, as the holidays approach, you gotta stay hydrated. Out there shopping for gifts, you're maybe traveling back home or traveling on vacation, you're hosting the family and you can deal with all that stress, or hey, you're just recovering from having a little bit too much at the annual Christmas party.
Here I am, running around the store. What minion doll am I gonna buy, Wags? Which one's the best? I'm sweating it up. I need to be hydrated, Wags, so I can think clearly. And also, what's the answer?
Bob. No matter where or how you're hydrating this season, Liquid IV is the hydration brand fueling your well-being, and their hydration multiplier can keep you going through the end of the year and beyond.
With 3 times the electrolytes of the leading sports drink, plus 8 vitamins and nutrients for everyday wellness, Liquid IV hydrates 2 times faster than water alone, all in a single stick.
Now it's available in sugar-free. Choose from 3 delicious flavors, white peach, green grape, and lemon lime.
Ooh.
And you know what, Mitch? Liquid IV is for everyday hydration, not just for high energy athletic endeavors. You don't be getting a sweat in on the treadmill or at the gym. You sometimes just need it just to stay hydrated as you go about your business.
Wags, at the end of the day, you know what? Sometimes I have a big salty meal. I'll put some water in a cup, I'll add some Liquid IV, and I'm good to go. I like the strawberry. I'm a strawberry guy. I love that strawberry flavor. Or you know what? I remember New Year's last year, me and all the Quincy guys. The Quincy crew, we gathered around the table. We all drank Liquid IV together.
Oh, what a nice new tradition. You know, for me, it's the sugar-free flavors, the white peach, which is robust and satisfying, and the green grape, which is tart and crisp.
1 stick of Liquid IV in 16 ounces of water hydrates better than water alone, with 3 times the electrolytes of the leading sports drink, contains 8 vitamins and nutrients for everyday wellness, and is non-GMO and free from gluten, dairy, and soy.
Wow. Grab your Liquid IV Hydration Multiplier sugar-free in bulk nationwide at Costco, or you can get 20% off when you go to liquidiv.com and use code Doughboys at checkout. That's 20% off anything you order when you shop Better Hydration today using promo code Doughboys at liquidiv.com.
Do it.
Welcome back to Doughboys with Lisa Gilroy. It's time for our fork scores on Milk Bar. So Lisa, here's how this will work. We will each go around, give a closing argument, if you will, on this particular chain, and then end that by giving it a score from 0 to 5 forks. So you are our guest. We'll begin with you. Your thoughts, your fork score.
okay, I think a little too sweet, but that's funny. And for parties, sweet is good. And after dinner, sweet is yummy. So I also think you'll look rich if you bring this to your friends' gatherings. True. The branding is gorgeous. You'll look like an influencer. The cakes look very pretty. You just can't eat all of them, which maybe even an argument, one slice could feed a family of eight. So I'm going to give it three forks.
Three forks.
Three forks, pretty good score.
Yeah.
By the way, in The Killer, Fassbender has a shower scene, and I was surprised that he didn't, like, Fincher didn't show his hog.
Famously big hog. I was looking for it, because he's, like, kind of, like, he's sitting in the shower, and I feel like he can kind of see it, but it's through frosted glass.
If he's sitting, it's probably flopped down the drain, then. That's probably why you couldn't see it.
Yeah, he's got a fucking hanger.
Some guy at the Department of Sanitation is like, huh?
It comes and taps him on the shoulder in his office. How'd this thing get so far down the drain? What's this? The slide a mile, slip and slide?
It's a living. Wow. Three forks.
And 7 years ago.
Independence Day. That's funny. It's Lincoln, you know.
Yeah.
What was that speech?
Good movie, by the way, for you guys, if you're thinking of doing Doughboys content. Independence Day, and it could be an action movie starring you two.
That's
a good idea.
Your pitches for Doughboys are better than what we have.
I'm going to connect you guys with me. And we'll have a talk after this again.
What was that speech that...
Like, it's the Gettysburg Address.
It's the Gettysburg.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gettysburg Address. Thank you, Casey. Should maybe host the show.
Yeah.
Milk bar. What do I say?
Take another quiz. Find out if you're Getty.
I think that's a perfect way to sum it up. You know, it's not bad. I don't feel great after eating it. I told you, like, I already was feeling foggy. But then, honestly, maybe that sugar buzz is, like, counteracting the fog. And because the sugar buzz is real. That's a lot of sugar. I don't think it's necessarily bad, but I also think it's, like, I kind of think it's not great. I think, like, ordering a whole... milk bar pie, because you can't say crack pie anymore.
And yet you still found a way to do it.
Wigs, you know I support the boys in blue, but when it comes to the woke police... did I do this joke already on the
you
last...
You did that in Your Kickstarter Sucks.
Oh, okay.
It was funny, though.
All right, yeah.
Yeah.
I support the police, but not woke police.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go a little higher than our guest, Lisa. I think I'm gonna go 3.5 forks.
What? I'm shocked. There were so many times in the eating of this, you sighed deeply and said, "Does Milk Bar suck?"
Yeah, you seem like the least enthused of all of us. Is it just because you have like you're more of a dessert guy? I don't think you are a dessert guy, though.
I'm not really. I'm not a huge dessert guy. I just do think that like if you get the Milk Bar pie or something, it is, like you're saying.
Crowd pleaser.
Maybe, yeah, you know what? I'm going to go with our guests. I think three forks maybe nailed it for me. I don't think it's bad. I think it's expensive. I think it's very sweet.
That's not true. It was only $90 for us to get those four slices.
I think it's expensive. I think it's overhyped. It's too fancy. Weiger's just trying to get Jemmy on the couch. He doesn't care at all.
If you
about
move that
anything
pillow,
anymore.
Hop
you think
up
so?
Yeah. Go ahead, good girl.
Perfect spot for it over your lap. That won't freak her out anymore.
She's like, oh no, this guy's hiding a boner. I can't sit next to
him. She's just looking away now. She was looking at me earlier.
It's also just like
now she's looking at mommy.
It feels like to me, it's like the Milk Bar at this point. And I don't think that because again, that pie is good.
Yeah.
But it's the equivalent of like taking a selfie at the thing with the wings behind you in LA or something.
Oh, interesting.
That mural with like the angel wings,
sure,
or something. It just is like, I don't know. Not to say, because Momofuku is good, right? Like it.
I like Momofuku.
The food, like it's quality products. That's why I'm going a little higher. It's just like, It kind of sucks, but also I get that the desserts are like quality enough. Too sugary though for me. That is an issue. So three forks. I'm with our guest. Our guest did a great job.
We're gonna be ballpark buds here. It's three forks for Wags.
Wow.
I here's the thing. The stuff I think is good. And from the standpoint of like it achieves what Milk Bar is trying to achieve, being like this high end, you know, destination spot for luxury desserts. I think it succeeds at that. The thing is, I would not tell anyone to go out of their way to go to Milk Bar. I would be like, if you want to try it, you're curious, go for it. And it probably will, you know, satisfy that curiosity in terms of delivering what you'd expect from their signature Milk Bar pie or their crunchy cereal shake or whatever the fuck. But this is not a place I would go to for regularity. I think that's a great point that like it works well as a gift or as a party favor. From that standpoint, I think it succeeds. But yeah, just punishingly sweet. And I'm just over dessert. And also, I don't know, like, is this that much better than a grocery store cake slice? I don't know if it is, you know? And if it's like, I just need something sweet right now.
But that's the huge difference for me. It's like, if you stop and get a cake, slice of cake for someone's birthday, it's going to come in that like crinkly little cellophane thing pocket divots and a sticker on it that says paid and a sticker on the side that says pavilions. And you're going to give that to somebody. It's like Milk Bar, you're like paying for the wonderful outfit it's wearing.
I fully agree. I think you're correct. And that's why I think it lands in the three fork territory.
Milk Bar is like a coffin. You want to buy it, but you don't want to use it. You want to give it to someone else.
Wow. That is a great point.
You want to buy coffins for other people.
And I always do, baby. I got a couple for you cuties waiting in the truck outside.
I worry about getting into a coffin like feeling too comfortable. Do you ever have that feeling? It's like, oh, this is cozy.
Have I ever had that feeling? No.
I feel like if I tried one out, I'd just be like, oh, I like
you
it.
You think you're going to try one out?
Well, wouldn't you?
Are you okay?
I feel okay.
I mean, here's my thing that I just decided. I almost said this is my thing about coffins. It was never my thing before this moment right now. But the satin pillows inside and all that, they do look awfully comfortable. But I bet it's like those couches they use for staging homes. They look so comfy, but you don't want to sit on them because the person who's laying in it isn't going to actually care if it's comfortable or not.
Right.
Where are you going to get your coffin at? Fucking DXL? Where are you going to get your fucking big boy coffin from? You fucking...
You know, Mitch, as you and Lisa were talking through your fork scores, I actually had a browser tab open and was taking the gay test myself.
Oh, wow.
And it's interesting because I got to, I don't know if you got
it's
this
his
far.
Page.
Let's just say both these men this entire time have been independently taking the gay test. No one's made eye contact with me once. Just in talking to me.
I don't know if you got this far, but there's a point in the test, like towards the end, where they ask for your name.
Oh, yeah.
And so I put in my name. I put in Nick, and it gave me an error, and it asked for my full legal name.
Yeah.
And I had to type it in because, you know, my full legal name is Nicholas Frank Weiger. And sometimes I go by Frank.
Wow.
Which means it's time for this week in seasonal hot dog news and a special edition of Let Me Be Franksgiving.
Wow, Let Me Be Franksgiving.
They're behind you.
You don't have
to. Yeah, you don't have to.
Hot dog, simmer in the city. Grate on my grill, getting greasy and gritty. Toast bun, don't it look pretty? Sucking on a dog like you're sucking on a titty. Pork and beef, sausages and long bread. Rolling on a roller grill, mustard and relish. One bite, it's a different world. Swap dog bites with a girl. Munch on and chomp all night. Despite the farts, it'll be alright. That taste. When the casing has snapped, later that day you'll for sure have to nap as it simmers in the city like you're sucking on a titty. You ain't nothing but a hot dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hot dog, crying all the time. You ain't never been a burger and you ain't no lunch of mine. Well, they said you a sandwich. Well, that was just a lie. When they said you a sandwich, well, that was just a lie. You're just a bun around a wiener, so you shouldn't qualify. We've been through this such a long dog time, just trying to grill a Frank.
Oh yeah. Lunch is always coming, lunch is always going. No one's really sure who's eating dogs today. Chomping away. If we could take the time just to fry it on the line, I could stuff my gut just knowing that we could dine. All mine. So if you're feeling hungry, then darling, don't refrain.
Oh man.
Or I'll just end up munching on the grilled November frank. Do you feast sometime on your own? Do you feed sometime all alone? Ooh, everybody feeds sometime on their own. Ooh, dog, you know you feed sometime all alone.
How may I help you?
You can start by wiping that franking dumbass Frank off your golden toasted bun. Then you can give me some franking ketchup, a franking Highs, a franking Hunts, a franking French's, a franking Del Monte, 4 franking squirts from a bottle.
Oh, I really don't care for the way you're speaking to me, buddy.
And I really don't care for the way your podcast left me in the middle of franking nowhere with franking mustard for a franking dog that wasn't franking there. And I really didn't care to franking walk down a franking highway and across a franking runway to get back here to have you smile at my franking face. I want a fucking frank right franking now.
May I see your frankel agreement?
I threw it away.
Oh boy.
Oh boy, what?
You're franked.
Wow.
Wow.
Thank you for helping us out there, Lisa.
I want to say this. I watched the video of that like 10 times,
yeah,
and I didn't do close to what Steve Martin did, and you nailed your part almost exactly.
Great character actor Edie McClurg, your rendition of her performance.
You knocked it out of the park.
Very well
also,
done.
Lisa was taking video of you, and I think she sent it to her manager and said, don't allow this to happen ever again. Don't let me be on this show ever again. But she did a close-up of...
I'll show you.
She did a close-up of your hand on your...
Yeah, do you know that you do this?
What is it? Oh, I kind of like got the middle finger up. I didn't realize it was a position like that.
I will say this.
For hours.
For our guest here, we really did not explain any of this to you.
Yeah, we didn't give you any context
for
what was
scared.
Happening.
My heart was racing. I felt scared. I felt fight or flight coming in.
I don't blame you. Well, now we're gonna Google.
Yeah,
I think I should. I'll Google Thanksgiving hot dog.
I think I'm gonna do the same. I'm gonna using my preferred search engine, Microsoft.
What if you do
Bing.
Holiday hot dog?
I'll do holiday hot dogs in Bing. And this is Let Me Be Franksgiving. So yeah, basically what this is, Lisa, is we just look for our hot dog news and then we talk.
Can
about
I look?
It. Yeah, sure. Of course. Yeah. I mean, this is unprecedented.
So,
what
am I
but
supposed
why not?
To Google hot dog? Well, I've already Googled Ben Affleck penis show, which is kind of hot dog news.
So if you search hot dog and then news, I searched Thanksgiving hot dog and then clicked news.
Why do you want it to be Thanksgiving?
Just because it's Let Me Be Franksgiving. We're doing
yeah,
the
it's just kind of a seasonal thing.
And Wags, I'm going to say it right off the top. Columbus Eatery offering Thanksgiving-themed hot dog with stuffing, mashed potatoes, gravy,
ooh,
and
that
more.
Sounds
wow.
Good. Reporter goes viral for shocked reaction to taking huge bite out of Polish hot dog.
What was the shocked reaction, I wonder? Do you have any more context on that?
This is a porn parody, I can guarantee it.
Oh, got it. Do you have, because we're coming up on American Thanksgiving. What can you give us any context for Canadian Thanksgiving? Was that a thing you ever celebrated?
Yeah, it's over now.
It's over?
Yeah. Happened in October.
Wow.
And it's not that big of a deal. It's like family dinner if you want.
Kind of its own thing.
Familydinnerifyouwant.com.
Here's a good one. Man who ate 62 hot dogs in 10 minutes reveals how he feels after.
Ooh.
This is from Unilad. Oh, this is, and you know who it's about, Wags?
Who?
It's about Chestnut.
Joey Chestnut?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
The man who impressively ate 62 hot dogs in 10 minutes, yes, you read that correctly, reveals what his body feels like after. And spoiler alert,
he doesn't feel like going on a big hike.
Okay, 62 hot dogs in 10 minutes?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking full swallow of the hot dog, sausage link from the bottom of the intestine all the way to the top of the mouth.
That'd be amazing if that's what happens.
Stack them up.
Yeah.
That's the only way to do it. And then you basically have to count on your guts, like, squeezing the hot dogs into chewing it into poop for you.
Right. That's disgusting.
Well.
It's like a variation of the piss guy. Here's this is kind of interesting, so I will say it. Most people relate to feeling really bloated and tired after Thanksgiving, Joey told Business Insider. It's kind of like that, except really, really bad. People have told me they can smell the hot dogs, Joey said. I really can't, but the sweat afterward, it feels sticky and greasy. My girlfriend says it smells different.
Oh, God.
That's also, people talk about that after doing Doughboys. Doughboy smell you get.
God.
It's hard on the body. There's no way around it. Joey's 39, or was 39. How old is he? Let's see here. Oh, that's this from this year, so he's 39.
Mitch, I searched for holiday hot dog on Bing. I'm getting a lot of Halloween stuff, which is going to feel a little bit dated, unfortunately.
I'm getting
but that's
it
just
too.
Coming up. Here's one that I got. I'm going to read through this because I don't know its connection to hot dogs at all. Dunkin's holiday menu just dropped, including two new items.
Interesting.
America's largest donut chain, just like Mariah Carey and Starbucks, could not wait for Halloween to be over to officially welcome the holiday season. So this is a post-Halloween thing.
I got a Halloween one. House of Frankfurter, the Glenn Allen family gives hundreds of hot dogs to trick-or-treaters.
That's fun.
That's kind of fun to get a hot dog on
if
on
it's
holiday.
Wrapped.
Yeah. Yeah,
I don't want a wet hot dog banging around next to my lollipop.
Yeah, that's nasty.
You guys, please don't get that snippet of me saying that.
Here's the issue. This Dunkin' article doesn't have any stuff about hot dogs. It talks about the Bark Dunkin' dog toys. It's one of those, we run into this sometimes with a segment, Mitch, where the search results are giving us dog stories instead of hot dog specifically stories.
Well, here's one, Wags. Figgy pudding spam tastes like a hot dog fruitcake.
Wow.
Run away.
Figgy pudding spam.
Oh, there's also the Brock's candy corn, which people gave us, they were like, eating 60 pieces of candy corn is that hard? It was kind of hard. It sucks.
It was awful. I hated that.
60 pieces of candy corn was gross.
We did that on our Patreon in October, and that was a user pitch. That was a Discord listener pitch.
But there's...
It did suck.
There's a candy corn hot dog flavor. Brock's makes that, the tailgate Wags, and one of the flavors of the candy corn is hot dog. I'm going to help you guys out here. I'm going to Google Christmas hot dog.
Do you guys like 46-year-old woman dies after Tesla crashes into hot dog store?
I don't think I like that, no. I don't like it.
Okay.
Your question was, do we like it?
Here's one. The store-bought snack Julia Child always served before Thanksgiving dinner. Famous charismatic home cook, this is from Food Republic. Famous charismatic home cook Julia Child is beloved for many reasons, and one of them is this.
Say it in a Julia Child voice if you can.
Can't do a Julia Child.
Try.
It's kind of a Julia. That doesn't
That's
sound like her.
Good. Isn't
what the hell?
Really?
It sounds like Shaggy.
Scoop, we gotta serve something before Thanksgiving dinner. One of Child's favorite store bought snacks made an appearance at her Thanksgiving dinner every year. Goldfish. Yup, those cheddar fish-shaped crackers that you grew up munching on were served at the Child residence alongside what was undoubtedly an impressive homemade holiday spread. Why Goldfish? Because these crunchy, cheesy crackers perfectly complemented the chef's go-to martini. The hot dog connection is that it talks about how she also loved Costco hot dogs.
In her martinis?
Yeah, as a garnish.
I think here's one that I think already, as you can tell, this segment is a great segment, and after the songs and the scene, there's still a lot to do.
Right.
Yeah.
I'll say two things. One, a Christmas miracle. Subway UK launches vegan bacon wrapped hot dog subs.
Wow.
Is that real? And then finally, I think this is a fun thing to just end on, Wags. Hot dog. Oscar Mayer Wienermobile appearing in Broadmoor Christmas Parade. Christmas is coming up. The Wienermobile gets itself involved. That's nice.
That's a lot of fun. That's great.
You get to see Santa in the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. That's fun.
Your Planes, Trains, and Automobiles spoof should have been Planes, Franks, and Wienermobiles.
That's maybe it is. Maybe that's the
maybe
title.
It is. Maybe that's what it's called.
That's what it's called.
Vinod, put that in the Doughboys Wikipedia. Just like put that in canonically.
Can't hold on. Don't enter it yet. Can't we workshop Planes? Because it's the only one that doesn't get like a food parody.
Sure. Plain bagels.
Plates
is good. Plates, Franks, and Wienermobiles.
That's good.
Vinod, put that in. Vinod, I'm serious. Put that in the fucking Doughboys Wikipedia. You better.
So you're just doing it to this one man.
The volunteer who is our friend. Yeah. I'm warning you, Vinod.
No one, you think anyone will check on this to make sure that it's correct? I mean, you know what? Maybe they will.
I think they will.
Why?
Something tells me the police have a close eye on both of you. So I'm sure someone will be checking something.
I think Weiger was actually mad at Vinod. I can't believe he yelled at Vinod.
Those are our listeners.
Yeah.
That was a good Julia Child. You finally called
her. Hey, that was Let Me Be Franksgiving, just like a restaurant value feedback. Let's open up the feedback. Today's email is from Dylan. Dylan writes,
"Hey, how are you doing? Bob Dylan.
Oh, Dylan.
Dylan writes, "Time for soup. What is the best soup?"
Wow.
This is
time for soup.
This is a great feedback question.
Did you spell time T-H-Y-M-E?
You should have.
Time for soup?
No, just T-I-M-E.
The node, put that. Put it in. Put it in the
Wikipedia that time is spelled T-H-Y-M-E. Put it in there.
Yeah, put it in. What is the best soup?
I love this question. Can I just say? Because a lot of times our feedback question is like, imagine a world where all the different fast food chains are kingdoms. Yeah. What would your kingdom be in?
Or like imagine like a stupid fucking question like, do you like garlic?
Yeah, exactly. Like, we get dumb fuck questions like that. Some fucking dipshit writes in and writes, "Hey, do you like garlic?" We're like, yes. Where's the discussion come from here?
My favorite soup is a bowl of hot ketchup with letters in it. That's right. I'm talking about Alphagettis.
Wow, you really like Alphagettis. An alphabet soup.
Yeah, you know it?
No, that sounds Canadian to me.
Oh, is it?
Alphagettis.
Well, I've heard of alphabet soup. I didn't realize Alphagettis was its own thing.
Oh, you guys call it alphabet soup?
Yeah.
That's kind of cute. Alphagettis is a better name, right? Because it's like spaghettis?
Yeah, it's more fun. I like it being a
pun. I like Alphagettis. I think it's fun.
I like Alphagettis.
I mean, I think I like it. I think it does
it
taste like
also sounds like
hot ketchup.
Star Wars character.
Alphagettis.
Alphagettis. I guess Alphagettis is his own alien.
Yeah.
He's his own kind of alien.
Yeah, the questions are usually like, are you my friend? Like, it's, you know, like our listeners just asking if we're friends with them. And we say, yes, we are.
Yeah, we are.
You know what I've gone to? I think I'm a tomato. God bless my sweetheart. I'm a tomato soup man.
You're a tomato soup man.
Yeah, God bless my sweet little heart.
What do you mean, God bless my sweetheart? I'm a tomato soup man.
Because who would have thought it? I never thought I'd be a tomato soup man. And now here I am.
Bless
as
your
an adult.
Sweetheart.
Sounds
your
like
tomato
a catchphrase for a superhero. Bless his sweetheart. He's a tomato superman.
God bless me. I can't
God
believe
God bless
it.
You indeed.
God bless you. God bless your sweetheart.
Thank you.
This is a great question. I really think like, okay, what's a soup that I really love that always is hitting for me? And I think it's a pho bovine. I think it's a pho with meatballs. Oh, I think it's just like, it's such a...
I mean, it counts. So it's, just,
it's so comforting.
You know my rule about soups.
No, you have to bless his heart,
bless
too.
Bless my sweetheart.
Everyone's sweetheart blessed for their different soups.
Bless your sweetheart.
Thank you. No, I think it's just, like, I'm just... It's so rich and satisfying, and I just think I'm just trying to think of like what like where does my mind go when I say time for soup? What is the best soup? That's where I gravitate towards, and so that's why I kind of think that's maybe my answer. But I mean, there are many soups that I like, so many soups I enjoy.
My nose started running once we started talking soup. I'm not sick. I was sick 2 weeks ago. Everyone relax.
It must be the CPAP machine.
And I think it is. I think it's CPAP craziness. I gotta throw this thing in the trash.
You should put some soup in that.
So where I put the water, put soup and like inhale soup every night could be nice.
Could be nice.
Your doctor does your blood work. You've been inhaling soup? Make your CPAP into a soup pap?
Soup pap.
You did, didn't you?
That's funny.
I think tomatoes, it's now, I remember I shoveled and my mom and I went and got some tomato soup from Panera.
dip some bread and
tomato soup.
Some bread and butter. Butter to the bread, then dip it into
grilled
the tomato
cheese
soup.
Sandwich, why not? Have a dunk.
It's fun. I've come around, did not like tomato soup as a boy. Now I'm a tomato soup guy.
Bless your sweet heart.
Bless my sweet little heart.
Little boy.
Emma Casey, favorite soup? Best soup? Time for soup?
I love a tomato soup too, but I'm a big broccoli cheddar. I almost said chocolate bread.
I was thinking broccoli cheddar, especially when Mitch said Panera.
Yeah, a broccoli cheddar in a bread bowl.
Mm.
Classic.
That is hitting.
Can I also just say that we there was a thing where I said rank the soups, and I said soup versus pho versus ramen.
Here are your categories.
Yeah.
And it's important, I think, that the order I think is important. Said, what's the best soup? Well, like, what are your here categories? Ramen, pho, chowder, and soup.
Yeah.
Those are your four categories of soup. That was your soup taxonomy.
Yes.
Soup was its own.
Ramen,
pho, chowder, and soup.
Those are the original Spice Girls names.
I was a huge soup fan of all the Spice Girls. You were a chowder guy.
Yeah, I was team chowder.
I
just don't think that, I don't think that works.
I just think that, look, when you were like, all right, fair enough, because I feel like I got in trouble for last time saying, like, pho and ramen are different. To me, they're special. I mean that in a good way. They're, like, a special.
But you've also got, like, soup. You know, if we're talking about, like where do you put, like, an, if we're talking about soups from other cultures, where do we put, like, an albondigas? Where do we put, like, a, you know, like, a Thai soup? Like, where do those fit into your categories?
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it just gets a little complicated.
You know all the foods of the world?
I do, yeah.
What's, can I say a country and you tell me their most wonderful dish?
Okay, sure.
Like, the dish of their flag, if they had a dish on their flag?
Sure, I'll do my best.
Okay, Sweden.
Fucking lingonberry jam.
Lingonberry jam? Lingonberry. Yeah.
Lingonberry.
You could have said Swedish meatballs.
Well, we're just talking IKEA now.
I was thinking IKEA. That's the only thing I could think of, is I think they have like a lingonberry thing there.
Say a country.
Australia.
Dunkaroos.
This is all a charade.
Estonia.
I actually don't know I should know this.
Tisk, tisk.
I should know this. I'm ethnically Estonian. I should know what the Estonian food is, but I've never been there.
Have a go at Latvia, then.
Swedish meatballs. Casey, do you have a favorite soup?
Or say something from Latvia. Your choice.
I don't know anything from Latvia, and I'm also not much of a soup guy.
Not much of a soup guy.
That's fair.
That's wild.
Yeah. I'll like have like miso soup if I'm
yum.
That is fun.
But it never really does it for me.
Wow.
Yeah, that's fair.
It just keeps me busy while I wait for the rest of my
exactly.
Food.
Exactly.
That's fair. People will love that. Casey's right. They'll say. That's what they'll say. You know, in the Star Wars universe, the soup is green. It's green soup.
No, that's the milk.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's purple soup. I was fucking with you.
Yeah, I know you were fucking with me.
That one was fake, except I fucked up and said the one that you already knew, that there was green milk, which there wasn't green milk until Last Jedi. Whatever. We won't get into it.
You should go to Galaxy's Edge dressed as Elf.
Hey, that would be fun.
Let's do it as a prank.
That's fun.
The three of us, 1 year from today.
Okay, I'll pledge.
If he hasn't, been to Galaxy's Edge, I think that's a good reason.
We'll all go 1 year from today, dress in Elf cosplay, and see everyone's reaction.
Yeah. Also, for everyone listening, we got an email about touring in 2024. Weiger gave a hard no. Just so you know, I don't think we're going to be touring next year.
We did a lot of dates in recent years. If you have a question or comment about the world of chain restaurants, you can email us at doughboyspodcast@gmail.com or leave us a voicemail at 830-GO-DOUGH. That's 830-463-6844. And to get the Doughboys Double, our weekly bonus episode, join the Golden or Platinum Play Club at patreon.com/doughboys. You can also find our pre-HeadGum back catalog there, patreon.com/doughboys. Lisa Gilroy, our guest, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks for staying right up until your heart out. We apologize for going so long. But thank you very much for making time for us. What a treat. Do you have anything you'd like to plug?
I just want to say that if you guys are the Doughboys, I'm an honorary Timbit. That's from Tim Horton's Little Donut.
Wow.
That's all I want to plug. I guess, like, if people are going to be in the comments, say, like, oh, Timbit was good to see Timbit. I agree with Timbit, stuff like that.
Yeah, honorary Timbit.
I just thought it'd be good to kind of like shoehorn a nickname in for myself at the last second.
No, to be the Timbit. I like that. I think that'll work for you.
I think it's great.
Yeah.
Thanks.
No one's claimed it.
We have a lot of Canadian guests that maybe will be mad at this, but you get it.
No one's claimed it?
No one's claimed
it. Okay, and then I guess I'll also plug, I have a podcast with Ike Barinholtz and Neil Casey coming out next month. Wow. Well, I don't know when this is coming out, but it's called The Chris Chapman Do-Over. So
wow, check for that.
Soon. Yeah.
Check for it. Why don't you?
Yeah.
Add it to the wiki.
Vinod?
Yeah. And now, get the hell out of here.
Okay.
That'll do it for this episode of Doughboys. Until next time, for the Spoon Man, Mike Mitchell, I'm Nick Weicker. Happy eating.
See ya.
Hey, buddy, it's Weiger. Breaking Chews. Get Played, the video game podcast I co-host with Heather Ann Campbell and Matt Apodaca, is now right here on HeadGum. Listen to Heather, Matt, and me, Weigs, talk about good games, bad games, and every game in between every Monday. Get Played on HeadGum. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. Wow. Sources for the intro are in the episode description.
That was a HeadGum podcast.